Oh my god! What? Oh, wasn't that just insane? Who said I was playing Minecraft today? Not me. I didn't speak a word of the sort. Let me just update this one. This is an absolute fucking mess. So this is why I don't ever try and do anything different. I'm just gonna stick to my normal schedule. I'm just gonna stick to not playing Minecraft because I think that's what I do best. Hang on. Fuck, I can't even spell the word everyone, man. Oh no, and the music is so boring. Get the music back up in energy. Come on. Up energy, up energy, up energy. Come on. Yeah, that's like the most depressing song. Why is all the... No! Come on. Woo, woo, woo. Why is it just skipping to Wilbur's fucking album? Oh my god. There we go. There we go. Look at this. Woo, woo. Take that back. No, Minecraft. Just talking. That's not how you spell no. Fuck. Shit. Fuck. There we go. Okay, I did it. Bish, bash, bosh. That was easy. And they took me 10 minutes to get back to normal. Hello, everybody. Welcome on into the stream. Happy Friday. Let's pretend like that never happened. What random streams? I didn't see any of that. Nope, I didn't see any of that, and neither did you. We'll live in denial like we're in Egypt. Happy Friday, everybody. How are we all? How's everybody's day been? Guess what? Even with the absolute mess of a start, this is the first time I have streamed 4 days in a week for a long, long while. For about 2 months, I have not stuck to my schedule. And here we are, first week in a while, and it's already a fucking mess. It wouldn't be a Sugar Daisy stream without it. Now let's get more chill songs. Hello, welcome on in. All good, nothing broke. What? I would never break anything, not me. Hello, Draco though, welcome on in. Happy Friday, and hello, Matt as well. Welcome on in, everybody. I really need to fix my internet. But hello, welcome on in. I've had a really underwhelming day, which is why I was gonna try and do something different because I've got nothing to talk about today. Absolutely nothing. Like my days for the past 2 days have just been, hey, I don't have to go to college anymore, so I'm gonna do nothing. I'm going to do zero. I'm going to do absolutely fucking nothing. Only thing I've done 2 days in a row, wash my hair, and both of the times they fucked up greatly. Like the only things I've sat and done in the past 2 days is wash my hair, and both times it went wrong. That's why I've not been doing anything. I don't have long because I'm at work. I got like 10 minutes. Why the fuck? Stop. What? Go work, man. Why are you watching me? Go and work. I appreciate you for being here. Go and do your job. Go and do your job. But no. Yeah, I've just had a really dull day. Apart from the stream title, look at this! Look at this! I'm so excited about this. Look, 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 whoa, 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 whoa. It's clean! The majority of the whiteboard is clear. See, it looks it from a distance. You start at 7:30. I was about to say, what the fuck are you doing? Like, at work? Yeah, well, that's fair. You start really fucking late. What's your work, man? You start at 7:30. Look, it's clean. Shit. It's relatively clean, but the only thing that's stained slightly is when I wrote G-Dog Burn on it. So everything else pretty much cleared off. There is just a faint outline of me telling one of my Twitch chatters to burn on it, which I think makes a lot of sense. But now I've fucked up the whiteboard even more, because if I draw anything on it, that is not coming off. It took me probably like 20 minutes to clean this fucking whiteboard. It's a whiteboard! It shouldn't take that long. I had to sit and scrub with a sponge and like cleaning shit to try and clean a whiteboard. How have I broken it that much? How have I broken a whiteboard? I say write me on it. What, you want me to write your name? No, you? I can't mean no fucking hell. Don't fight too much, guys. Jesus. I can write both of you. There's enough room. It's okay. And then it will never come off. It will never, ever, ever come off of this fucking whiteboard. It will be permanently etched on. It's like a tattoo. Like, it won't fucking leave. And I've got to write it backwards. The funny thing is, obviously because I have my stream flipped, the whiteboard to me, hang on, let me do this. Basically, I have to write backwards so it looks good on stream, but it will look like dog shit in real life. So, it's just been a constant backwards G-Dog Burn on my screen. On my, like, whiteboard. Hang on. Oh. Ta-da! here's inverted sugar. Here's inverted sugar. This is the whiteboard in real life. This is my room layout in real life, okay? So if I write normally on this, it will look backwards. Look, I'll write my name on it, so I'm an addition to the board. Look, that will be backward. What the fuck has just happened? Wait, huh?
You would have said the same thing on the phone with your dad he was eating.
Why don't I understand what's just happened? What did I just do? I'm so confused what I've just done. I don't know. What? I thought that they would have. No, it does make sense. I just don't understand directions. Okay, yeah, this is my perspective, okay? But if I want to have my stream how I like having my stream, shut the fuck up. That's just how I write my G's, okay? Be quiet. There's no point for that. I'm your very important person. You do have the pink icon next to it. That's what it looks like on stream if I write normally. There we go. That's what I meant. That's the words that I meant to say. That took me too long to process. So I have to write all of your names backwards, otherwise it looks like that on stream. So it just looks like I've got some fucking cryptic shit on my fucking whiteboard. Like, I've just got, like, code all over my whiteboard. Am I really just filling it with all of your names? Is that what's happening now? It can be the viewer whiteboard, but backwards. It takes me a while to process how you write backwards as well. Thumb, your name is fucked up. It looks like shit. I've got the writing of a fucking like 10-year-old. It's really hard to write backwards and process that you're writing backwards at the same time. There you go. Now you're on my whiteboard. Merry Christmas. It's a Christmas present. It's a really neat looking Christmas present that looks really neat and will never leave. Oh. Why is everything going so wrong today? What have I done? Why did I fix my whiteboard? What's going on? I'm actually lost. Why did that just happen? Why did I fix my whiteboard? It just all rubbed off. What have I done? Matt, you seem to know things. What the fuck have I just done to my whiteboard? Why did it just rub off? I know that's what a whiteboard's... Shit, I just wrote that G forward. I fixed my whiteboard, apparently. What? I don't know how I've done this, and I don't feel comfortable with it. Shit, that R's forward. It's really hard to write backwards. Maybe it was just dirty all along? But it wasn't, it was broken. How have I done this? What have I done? Magic? I'm putting this whiteboard down. That whiteboard is staying on the floor now. You did the thing with the nail polish and now it's marker pen resist. Why have I... Did I just like scrub off the not white, the bit that I broke before? I don't know what I've just done. I'm putting that down and I'm not touching that for the rest of the stream unless I actually have to. No more whiteboard now. No more whiteboard because that has just absolutely made me have a fucking like a moment, a breakdown. I don't... Let's just not look at the whiteboard anymore. How's everybody else's days been though, guys? How's the rest of your days been? Because mine's been literally so uneventful. Like just, it has just been the most uneventful day ever. Just ever. The only interesting thing that happened today was a fucking, me and like, not, just a bunch of people from my school last year during like the first or second lockdown added me to a Snapchat group chat called a really funny name, Corona Time, and it became absolutely just absent. That group chat died after the first 2 days, and then today a fucking notification popped up from it that someone was just saving pictures from it, and everyone was like, what the fuck are you doing? Are you okay? Like, are you doing all right? Like, why are you, what? And that was the most interesting thing that's happened all day. So it's been a really fun day. I sat and I woke up in the morning and I watched someone play Five Nights at Freddy's Security Breach. I watched Faf9 because I realized that he was live and I had a lovely time watching him. It was the most frustrating thing I've ever seen, and the game looks like utter dog shit. It just looks really confusing. So that's what I did this morning. And then I didn't get out of bed until 2 p.m. And I ate chocolate toast. With chocolate spread on toast. And I had a lovely morning. And that was about it. And then I went and washed my hair. And I had 2 hours to sort my stream out. And I sorted my stream out, cleaned my whiteboard, and now I'm here. That was literally my entire day. I've done nothing. Not even like, oh, I've done nothing. And I did like small little things. I have done nothing. Like zero today. I have done fuck all. And it's been really lovely. I've been appreciated. Well done. Thank you. Thank you. You know, I'll take that well done. Happy Friday. Happy Friday, by the way. I will take that well done and I will run with it. I've quite enjoyed doing nothing all day. Oh, I lit a candle. I lit my wax melts and I was trying to make my room smell like peppermint. But I think I picked the wrong wax melt scent. It doesn't smell like peppermint in here right now. It smells nice, but I don't know what wax melt I put in. Basically, wax melt, if you don't know, is a candle. But like, I don't know what it smells like, but it doesn't smell like Christmas. And I wanted it to smell like Christmas. There's nothing about that, but anyway. Like, your room smells like opium. Yeah, my room smells like drugs now. No, I put that in, I put my mum's present in my wardrobe because I'm just praying that that's the one place she won't look. Because, like, why would you look in your daughter's wardrobe? So I hope she just doesn't see that. So if I left it anywhere else, she would find the present. Happy Friday to you. Thank you. I appreciate it. Happy very, very uneventful Friday to me. I love days like this for my own personal benefit. But then for stream benefit, fuck am I gonna say? Fuck am I gonna say now? Hey guys, I disabled sound alerts. Took me so long to fit. I disabled the channel point sound alerts. I did that and I meditated. I had a nice, calm, relaxing day. Took some nice deep breaths. Yes, well done. See, I did a Twitch thing. Proud of myself. I did it literally 5 minutes before the stream had to start because I'm an unorganized mess when it comes to stream stuff. Said that I'd make a TikTok like a week ago. Didn't do that. Did not do that. I was meant to go to my dad's yesterday to go see my grandparents, but I didn't. And I was quite upset about that because I was going to ask them if they can help me buy a PC. Because they are rich, they are balling, they like retired at 50. Like my grandparents, they got money. So I was like, well, if I could maybe ask them to help me get that. I didn't put my lights on. That's why my room looks so depressing. I was so unprepared for this stream, if you can't realize. I was just not even like halfway ready to being like ready for this stream. I was not close to being ready. So there we go. Look, we'll put my lights on, make the room look a bit less depressing. There we go. Look at that. I was wondering why it looks so dark in the mirror behind me. It's because I didn't put my lights on. There we go. Now I'm feeling in the mood to stream. Now here we go. Add that to the list of things that I did today. Turned my lights on. I was going to do painting, but then it got to the point where I was like, shit, I've only got 2 hours before stream. I don't know if this is anyone else's mindset. Does anyone else have the same mindset as me? As if like you wake up and you know you've got something to do on that day. You like physically cannot do anything before it. So like having 2 hours before stream, that's a lot of time. Like 2 hours is a long amount of time, and I give myself about 15 minutes to set up just in case everything goes wrong. 1 hour and 45 minutes, that's a long time span. Like that's more than any kind, that's a big amount of time. And I start there like, no, I've only got 2 hours, I cannot dare start painting because then I won't be ready in time for stream. Yes, I would have been. I 100% would have been. 1 hour and 45 minutes, plenty of time to paint. But no, my mind went, sugar, you can't do that, so just don't do that. Just sit instead. Just actually just go sit instead. So I did. And I might paint after stream instead because I don't really feel that tired today considering that I've literally been asleep half the day. I've got quite a lot of energy to just try and use up somehow because I need to try and use it up somehow. I was going to sit and do my actual artwork today as well for school and I just didn't do it. Doing nothing is good for health. Yeah, I know, especially after having a busy week at school. What I think is that I'm not wasting days currently because it's not even technically. Guys, Christmas is in 9 days or something like that. Does that not make you feel sick? Does that thought not make you feel absolutely disgusted just in the world? Like, that is, why has that come so fast? No, it makes me feel violently ill to think that Christmas is in, what, like 8 days now, isn't it? Yeah, because it's the 17th. In 8 days, it's Christmas. That makes me feel ill. That makes me feel like, why has this year gone so fast, but like months gone so individually really slow? I don't remember the start of this year, but it's Christmas in 8 days. Huh? What? Like, how? How is that how? How? I don't want it to be 2022. That's too many T's. It's like a really shit alliteration. 2022, it's awful and bad and I don't like it. But 2021, I'll stay here. 2021 and a half is what I'm gonna do. Sometimes I don't even want to think other things, like if I know I have something else to do a certain time, like an appointment or a call. So exactly, if I'm going out with my friends at like say 4, I will get up at like 11 and just be ready until 4 and do absolutely nothing, like, which is why streaming can sometimes be really bad for my like my productivity. I don't know how you pronounce that word, for being productive, because if I know I have to be live at 7 every day, any time past 5 o'clock is just completely void. Those 2 hours between 5 and 7, they are null. They're hours which I cannot do anything in. Otherwise, I'm not ready for streaming. I have to, like, those 2 hours, they are nothing anymore. Because that's usually when I get home from, not really when I get home from school. Oh no, it is. 5 is usually when I get back from school up until 7. So those 2 hours, they are nothing in time. They are nothing if I have to stream. So I have to try and be productive before that. But considering the fact I got up at 2 today, that gave me like 3 hours to be productive. And I chose not to do that. I chose not to. I am in my home for the past 3 years. You think Christmas would affect me? Fair enough. Fair enough. You're in school, you can afford to waste time. Can I though? Because I've got a psychology assessment a week after I go back. I've got shitloads of revision to do for that. I've got so much artwork to do. Like, an irrelevant amount of fucking artwork to do. I am weeks behind in art. Months, I would say, behind in art. Because I just didn't go into any of the lessons. Oh, I'm so good at art. I care about my levels. So who cares about that? Just chill. That is exactly what I'm doing. See, I'm just pretending like that isn't real until the week after Christmas. It's not real. Enjoy school days. I'll try. I spend most of them by myself though, so I don't know. I'll try. I had quite a peaceful time last Tuesday when I literally just sat by myself watching you boys podcast. They were fun. I quite like them. Thank you so much, Chuck MP4, for the follow. I appreciate it. I like the fact that you've got a capital. The capital, I appreciate people have capitals in Twitch usernames. I feel like it's a bold move. I don't have capitals, and I rarely ever see people who have capitals in their name. So having a capital, Matt, like you, having a capital in your name, it just feels fancy. Someone who has a capital in their Twitch name feels fancy to me. Feels like making a statement, proud of you. Because I feel like having lowercase letters, you should feel calm. You should feel like it's quite smooth. Capital, making a statement. Which is probably really reasonable, and that does make sense, because that usually means the start of a sentence. College hell will be difficult. I mean, that is what I'm in college. I don't know what you want from me. You don't have a capital in your name? No, I know, I don't want a capital in my name. I am heavily against capital letters in every other sense. The setting that turns off capitals on phones? I have that off. I don't like capital letters. But, unless they're in a Twitch name. Because then I appreciate it. Then it's making a statement. Any other sense, though, they are disgusting. Blech. Yuck. Don't like capitals in any other sense. But in typing, nice. But yeah, no. I think having no capitals makes it look smooth. Makes it look nice and smooth and fluid. And I like it when it looks like that. So I made an active effort not to have capitals in my name. And I don't ever want capitals in my name. If I ever see anyone spell my name with a capital S and a capital D, they're not allowed to follow me, and that is the rules. If you use capital S sugar, capital D daisies, that is a crime against me. That is an absolute, you may as well just come into my house and spit on me if you use capitals in that, like that in my name. You know, if you accidentally capitalize the S, I'll allow it. If you capitalize the D as if it's two words, that is literally like coming into my house and slapping me. Ugh. That is the worst form of insult you could ever use. I am heavily against that way of being capitalized. Hate English as a language capital or... I hate English as a language capital or small. Honestly? That is very fair. That is extremely fair. Nope, very fair. But no, I'm just heavily against capital letters. I just think they look too much in some senses. I'll type in full capitals and I'll type... No, just full capitals. No other senses, though. I won't really ever start a sentence with a capital letter unless it's in an exam. And even then, you know what? Well, you know what I am against fully in capital letters? Capitalizing eyes? Who decided that was a thing? who decided that we wanted to capitalize I's in the sentence? Like, okay, if I'm starting a sentence like, I am going to the shop, that's fair. But if you put an I, like, oh, in this first paragraph, I believe, and you capitalize the I, that makes me feel disgusted. Why are we choosing? It's like capitalizing a capital A. Why is I the only letter that gets capitaled? Capitaled? Capitalized. Why? I don't get it. We don't need a capital I. Get rid of it. Where did the I go? What do we need a capital I for? Who decided that the I would get the special treatment? Give it to all of the letters then. See, I don't like that. Should we be anti-capitalist? Well, hi there, hello Decal, welcome on in. Happy Friday. I'm complaining about capital letters. Disagree with them, English people probably. Fair. But no, capital I asked my English teacher once, I went to him, I went, sir, why do we use capital I's and no other capital letters? What is the point of that? And he just couldn't tell me. Please elaborate on why we use capital. I want to know why the I is capitalized. So in my criminology assessment, I just didn't capitalize any of my I's. I just left them uncapitalized. Because there was no need. It's an I. You can read that it's an I. Why? I want to know why we capitalize I's in English. Hello, Wills United. Welcome on and happy Friday. Complaining about capital letters. You mess with your teacher? I was really nice. Never heard someone hate capitals so much. They're just bad, Chuck. In your name, it's acceptable because it makes a statement. In usernames, makes a statement. But other senses, they're wrong. They are wrong. I didn't mess with my teacher, though. I just asked him politely. I just asked him. I went, sir, why are the I's capitalized in sentences? Why don't we do it with, like, other letters? And he couldn't explain to me. So I just don't do it anymore. So I just don't take time out of my day to go capital I, not capital, and then carry on. I just make it a little I. Because it's so much more fun. The little I gets special treatment as well because it gets a little dot. Gets a little hat, doesn't it? Gets a little, a little pizzazz. It gets a little pizzazz. And like the T's. T's, F's, and I's, they're the special letters. They're the letters that get the special treatment. Because if you think about it, a T without a little special treatment, just an L. It's just an L, but no. With that little, whoa! With a little, whoa! It becomes a T. And then with an I, just a little L. Just a little L, but with the whoa on the top of it, it becomes an I. And then F's just kind of an F. It goes, but no one really likes the letter F anyway. So you don't like the letter I capitalized? Then did I get the right? Fucking hell, I can't read. So you don't like the letter I capitalized? Then did I get that right? No, wrong. It looks like a capital L. Me and Joker, who was here earlier, we had this whole just time in, like, when we were messaging each other, where instead of typing a capital I, no, instead of typing an L, we type a capital I, because they look the exact same. They look the exact same. An L and a capital I, they're the same. So which is why we need to determine between them. I don't like it. I pictured you as someone that stops to draw a little heart over the I while writing an essay about some serial killer. No. But you know those people in, like, history classes? You know the people in history classes who used to, like, do really fancy title for just the most inappropriate topics ever? Like, they'd write, like, World War One, the killing of, what's his name? Like, Franz Ferdinand, and then italics. I used to do that. I was one of them people. I drew the line when it came to some certain topics in history, but I did used to write, like, history topics all fancy and, like, calligraphy, and then write the date in, like, a little fancy thing. I used to be one of them people, and honestly, I'm not ashamed of it. I had a great fun. Your whiteboard will get dirty trying to answer my question. Oh no. But I just cleaned it. Actually, I cleaned it and then I fixed my whiteboard. Look, I've got it on hand just so I can flex my whiteboard. How clean it is. Is water wet? See, I have had so many debates with people about this for just the stupidest of reasons. I feel like it is. Because, like, what else is wet then? Like, what else is wet if water isn't? Like, what classes of wet is water isn't wet? You get what I mean? You can't go, like, there has to be something in the world. This sounds so inappropriate. This is just an awful topic to go on to. There has to be something in the world that's wet if water isn't, okay? Because, like, you can't describe something as fuck me, I hate this topic. Can't describe something as wet if there's not, like, some sort of liquid on it. You know what I mean? Like, something has to be. Fuck, I don't know how to say this. Oh, but look, I'm just sounding really stupid right now. But, like, there has to be something on an object to make it wet. And that is usually, like, water or a liquid. So, yeah. Unless I'm just having a breakdown and I've got no clue. So water can be dehydrated. I don't fucking know, man. I'm not sure. I don't know. I would think it's wet. Or what else would be wet? You know what I mean? That's not true. Oh, I don't know what I'm saying. Is anything real? Capitals are awesome. They make the difference between Pog and Pog. You don't write Pog Champ, you write Pog Champ. You make a fair point. But that's different though, isn't it? That's very different, Chuck. I'm all up for the full capitals. I'm all up for typing things in full capitals. Pretty sure my stream title right now is typed in full capitals. You know what I mean? That's typed in full capitals. But capital letters at the start, I'm against that. Unless it's in a Twitch username. I'm having a breakdown. The Discord, yeah, there you go. That's a command that is usable. There you go, there's the Discord, everybody. Wow, look at me, I'm like a Twitch streamer. I am awesome. You should use your board. Why? I thought that I broke it. I did break it the other day. There, look, here you go. What do you want me to write on it? You can see the ring light in the background. Whoa, I think I still have broken it. Basically, I made it so that my whiteboard didn't rub off. It didn't rub shit off. And then I tried to show that today's stream and it rubbed off. So here's another test. I fixed my whiteboard. I fixed it. It used to not rub off. This morning it didn't rub off. Water is not wet. Yeah, but how? Okay, give me your reasoning on why water isn't wet, please. Because, like, what is wet then? What is wet? What would you class as wet? What would you class as wet if water isn't? You know what I mean? Because this seems pretty wet to me. It's not exactly dry, is it? It's wet. Surely that's the most, like, no, you dare type my name like that? That is just honestly, oh man, why would you type sugar daisies like that? It's honestly, that's just wrong. Look how wrong that looks. Ugh, yuck, and bad. Sugar daisies with a capital S and a capital D is honestly like someone going, it's just someone walking into my room and just kicking the shit out of me. That's what it feels like. Hello, Clumped. I love your name, Sam Clumped. You have the answer? Please go for it. Some wine is dry. No, but that's not true. Isn't that just describing the taste? Right? Right? Isn't that just like describing the taste? Thank you so much. Oh, fuck. How do you pronounce your name? I don't want to butcher it. I'm very sorry. How do you pronounce your name? I didn't even take into account in that I would not be able to pronounce your name before you follow. How do you pronounce it? Or like a nickname. I don't want to absolutely butcher it because it's got a letter in it. It's got a number in it. I don't want to fuck it up. I'll thank you anyway. Thank you so much, though. I appreciate it. Who the fuck cares? Too true. Honestly, I don't care if it's wet or not. It's water. It hydrates you. Brittany Charl for Days Fest. Just butcher it. Why are you saying I pronounce it like that? And you had to put the capital. No. Is the three taking place for an E? Or is it just there for like extra pizzazz? Because that there's two different circumstances there. Is it replacing an E or is it just there? I finished my finals today and I'm loving life. I slept like a log. Yeah. Woo. Do you reckon they went well? Honestly, that is exactly what I did. I finished my criminology test on Wednesdays and I have just been absolutely dead for the past 2 days. How did they go, Clumped? How did they go? No. The three is like, ah. Well, I feel we may have run into a bit of a problem here and that has just made it harder. I wish I never asked, honestly. I wish I didn't ask what the three stood for because that, I'm not even gonna attempt that. I got 179 out of 200, so the top of my class. Woo! Everyone give a round of applause to Clumped. Everyone give a round of applause to Clumped, everybody. Woo, woo, woo! Proud of you, Clumped. Good job. Getting better than me. I didn't even finish my exam and I had 8 hours to do it. I really fucked up that. It's fine. But no, water wet. I think that's just a stupid question that I honestly don't know if it could be answered. Like, how does that? I don't understand how it couldn't be. I told you to just butcher it. There you go, that was my best attempt, and I would just never address you by name anymore. Spelled like Nat. I don't know how to read names. I'm bad with names. Just in general, I'm really awful with names. Just let alone Twitch username, fuck me over. But no, I don't understand the question is water wet, so I've never usually said my opinion on it. I just kind of go, I don't know, man. I'm not sure. I don't know, man. You do you. It could be wet if you want it to be, and it can't be wet if you don't want it to be. Because some people will say, like, water isn't wet, just the thing that you're pouring it onto. Because, like, I feel like there isn't a real answer. So shit is letters for foreigners. I don't even know what it is. I don't even know what that letter is. I'll be quite frankly honest with you. I ain't got a clue what that letter is, so I deeply apologize. I'm just really unknowledgeable. I only know some Spanish words. That is the limit of my, like, that is the limit of my foreign language knowledge. I know the Spanish alphabet, I know the Spanish months of the year, and I know the Spanish word for lawyer, and how to say I like my house because it's big. And that is it. That is where my knowledge begins and ends. So not helpful things, like how to order in a restaurant, or like, any kind of simple knowledge. It's just any, like, Spanish person goes up to me, hola, I can go, me gusta una casa porque es grande. And they'll go, why the, pardon? Abogado, because that means lawyer. And los grifos means taps, or something like that. If I got desperate in Spain and I was in a life-threatening situation, I could just spell it out using the alphabet. But the only way I remember the Spanish alphabet is through a Spanish alphabet song. Like, I don't have any knowledge of it unless it's in the song context. So if I was, like, dying and I needed an ambulance, I would have to go, just like, really, like, just sing the letters if I was trying to get an ambulance kind of deal. But, you know, saying my house is big is the most important statement for rich people. I know how to say poverty as well, pobreza, or something like that. And taps, los grifos. Ta-da! Spanish is useless, learn French. I purposely didn't choose French in GCSE because I just found it really boring. I don't know, but I don't think I want to know. Suca tu madre means suck your mum. And suena un tu problema means sounds like a you problem, I'm pretty sure. From my basic knowledge. And los drogas means drugs. I didn't remember fuck all from my fucking Spanish lessons. I hated Spanish with a passion, and I picked it as a GCSE. Like, I screwed myself over with a Spanish GCSE. I passed it, and I passed it quite, like, decently as well. I think I got B, which, like, isn't bad. It was just quite a low B, which wasn't awful for how little I cared about the subject. I just waffled my way through it and copied the girl next to me because she cared about Spanish. And I was planning on doing an A-level, and I just sat there because I had to. Like, I had to pick one of the 5 subjects, and Spanish was one of them. So I just kind of sat there like, yeah, I don't really want to be here right now, but me gusta una casa porque es grande. And something like, es prohibido un chicle en escuela. It's prohibited to chew gum in my school. What a helpful thing to say to Spanish people. Not, please help, I'm injured. Nope. It is prohibited to chew gum in my school. How helpful. French won't get you anywhere, learn German. I have no interest in learning any language currently because I'm fucking awful at it. I have no skills or brain cells to learn languages very well. I learned the sign language alphabet. That's about it. Learn Arabic. I think I'd struggle a lot. I struggled to learn Spanish, and that's, like, not too difficult, honestly. I just got really bored of it. I think I'd be happy to learn a language outside of getting tested in that language, because obviously when I was learning Spanish, we had to learn certain topics of Spanish. I think it was literally just, hey, learn Spanish, you can actually use it in life. I'd enjoy it much more, because the Spanish I learned was all graded and tested and shit like that, but I didn't enjoy it. So I think I'd happily learn a language out of, like, going, you didn't do this right, you failed language. You failed language, you didn't do it, failed the language. So, like, I think I'd learn it out of the classes, but right now I have no interest in learning it. Language phobia? No. I just currently have no interest in learning it because I don't have the fucking brain cells to do that. Maybe when I finish college. What's a whiteboard? You can write shit on it, Damien. If you're an English-speaking country, you don't need to learn a language. My ass had to learn 4 languages because I travel a lot. I have learnt none, and I learnt sign language in primary school. This is a whiteboard. You can write shit on it. Hang on. Let me write hello for you guys. I have to write backwards, so just, like, don't yell at me for how shitly I write, okay? Don't yell at me. Look. Hello. Write shit on it. Why do you want me to write shit on my whiteboard? Sugar's American? Yep, I'm a sophomore. I'm in sophomore year. I like soccer and American football. Write shit on it? Fine. I'll rub it off, though, because it will be backwards and it will look strange. That's quite an easy word, because most of the letters... Oh, fuck, that looks backwards. Oh, there you go. Now it says hello, shit. I really can't write of, like, backwards. Writing backwards is a skill that you really have to focus to learn. Look at that fucking S. Looks like a really shit snake. Football. I love football. American football. And I'm a sophomore year. And I'm a junior in high school. You know it. You know it. That's actually all the things I know how to say. And, like, what other things do Americans say? What other things do American people say? I'm a sophomore, and that's actually my, like, basic knowledge of America. Sophomore, American football, and soccer in high school. There you go, that's it. I'm learning Russian, Chinese, and Korean. Yeah, I don't think I could do that. I don't think I'd do that. Languages are ass, I can't even speak my own. I mean, I struggle enough to say English half the time. But that's just because I speak really fucking fast. Like, honestly, before I started streaming, I had quite a slow pace in talking. As soon as I did my first ever stream on February 1st, I became Eminem, but in stream form. Like, I don't know what happened. I don't know what happened to me. I became fucking Lightning McQueen, but with talking. I was quite a slow talker before I started streaming. And then I realized that I just don't process words on stream, so I just speak constantly. There are no thoughts up in this little head. Zero. Tap on it and it's empty, it's hollow. You open it up, there's nothing in there. It's like a fucking, it's like the desert. So, there you go. That deer is about 230 hamburgers. Oh yeah, hamburgers. That feels wrong in an American accent. Hamburgers. 10 months. Whoa. Oh my. You just have to go follow it. Oh. Thanks, Nightbot. Cheers. I'm getting snaked out by Nightbot. What the fuck, Nightbot? Nightbot's not a real one. Nightbot is not a real one, man. They're just fucking lying to me. Nightbot is fake, honestly. What? Nightbot doesn't even deserve to be here. 2 weeks! Time goes fast, isn't it? Time goes insanely fast, scarily fast. There we go. No, time has gone too fast this year, but also just insanely slow at the same time. Also, I've been seeing way too many TikToks recently about the fact that we might go back into online school. And if I go back into online school for college, I'm going to fail my A-levels. I've said this before and I will say it again. Online school does not work. It does not work unless you really are passionate about school. It doesn't work. It was fucking awful. Should you turn off sound effects? I know, because they were so laggy, Thom. I can't have them on anymore. Once they get fixed, or once I attempt to fix them, maybe I will. But for now, they are staying off. They are not coming back on ever until I fix them. But no, online schooling, for my brain at least, doesn't fucking work. During year 10, I did nothing. Not in absolutely niche in fucking on. I did absolutely nothing. I woke up around 11. I sat, I looked at my online work, and I closed the tab. And I closed the tab and I played Sims. And that's what I did. I have online schools on Monday and Tuesday, and I want our cameras on. Ooh, thanks. Sounds, you want to cry? Just, I mean, it's not that bad. I used to have my camera on. Just make yourself as big as you possibly can on the screen and make it so you can see yourself on the screen. Or just say, hey, my camera broke, do this. Or just like do this and just put a piece of like blue tack over the top and go, I'm so sorry, my camera's broken. Just do that. There you go, that works. Online schooling rewards bad behavior. How? Please elaborate on that point. From what you've said so far, but no, I was fucking awful at online schooling. I don't know how I managed. They provide a camera? Oh yeah, shit, if you don't have a I don't know, otherwise fuck them. Just say your camera's broke. Say your webcam doesn't work. I bet everyone will be saying that anyway. Honestly, in my online schools, they said we needed to have our camera and microphone on. No one fucking had their camera and microphone on. No one did any of that shit. But no, if it becomes back to online schooling, every single stream will be 3 hours of me complaining about that shit. Because I did none of it. Like, not even a little bit. I scrolled through my work, and unless it was a final assessment that was important, I didn't do it. If it showed up as like, sugar, you have to do this otherwise you might fail, I did that. Didn't do any of the other shit. And luckily, it meant nothing. It meant absolutely nothing. I didn't need it. Oh my god, the stream right now? No, I tried to do something different today and it broke. No, another stream we can. Like, my college did jack shit all semester and finished the first year without any problems because of uni taking it easy on the students. You're very correct, Clumped. You are very, very correct. I did fuck all and I still pass all my GCSEs. But with college, if we go into lockdown and we have to do online school during college, that's me done. That is me, like, absolutely done. I'm struggling enough in person where I don't have to try and get the motivation to sit at my computer every day and do everything. I can't do work at home. I've been shit at doing homework for my whole life. I've always been so behind on it, let alone doing every single piece of work we physically have at home as well. I just won't do it. Like, I honestly, I've like any homework that I've been sat, I do the night before, and then I will just be sat doing all of the work the night before. It's a fucking mess. And now they're getting to the second year of medicine. Medicine. Oh, geez, that's terrifying, isn't it? That's scary.
That's quite scary.
At least mine was just a fucking Spanish GCSE that meant nothing. Imagine going into fucking medicine school and you did all the work through fucking Google Meet. That's fucking awful. But no, I just don't care enough to sit on an online meeting. Also, what's really funny is when I was on an online meeting last year, I had my microphone, but I had to hide it from everyone because if I ever wanted to speak, hey, I may as well use my fancy setup, eh? I have my ring light on every time. But I had to, like, push it down so no one saw that I was just sat there with a microphone and my camera quality just looked that slight little bit better than everybody else's because I had my background lighting and, like, my fancy setup ready. And I just sat there like, this is fun. It's gonna get to a point where I start adjusting my fucking microphone and shit. So yeah, that was a lovely time when I was doing my online meets. But no, my online meets were really fun last year because they weren't like sit and do lessons in like a meeting. It was sit and just review if you've done the lessons, and if you hadn't done the lessons, then you sat there and did nothing. Like, I didn't do any of the lessons, and I joined the Google Meets just so my attendance didn't go, like, fuck up massively for them. And it was like, hey, sugar, have you done this English work this week? And I went, no. And then they marked the people who did do it, and the rest of us actually just had to sit there with our cameras off the entire... It was great. It was really fun. I had loads of fun. But yeah, no. It was shit. It was so boring. And having an excuse that your internet is bad, I'm going to get a test for you, I'm going to get the vaccine, is a great way of skipping all the damn lists. Oh yeah, you just don't have to join in some places. I literally just went, hey, my electricity went out. So you guys have a nice hour, but I'm not doing this. One of college had to go get the vaccine 7 times. Well, it comes to the point where I think you catch on slightly. But they're really easy to skip. They're really easy to not do. And A-levels are kind of important. So if we go back into a lockdown and if I have online schooling again, as I've said, I'm focusing on Twitch over school, which shout at me all you want. Shout at me all you want. You can go, sugar, no, focus on school, focus on college. I will say to you, no. Do you want me to cry every day? because I will. I'm focusing on Twitch. If I have the opportunity, if I have a part of my life where I don't have to get up at 6:30 every day to get the bus and get back at 5, then I am focusing on Twitch. Shout me all you want. Shout me all you want. I don't care. I'm not going to change my mind. So if we go back into a lockdown, expect much more content from me, because that is the thing that I will be hyperfixating on during it. Not school, Twitch. And all my teachers can suck my dick about it. I don't care. Like, make me do something else. Make me. I won't. I will not. So yeah, if we go back into online schooling, I will cry every day and have a breakdown. Because I quite like going to school in person. As much as I hate my college, going to school in person is quite therapeutic. Not therapeutic, but you know what I mean? Like, the best part of college right now for me is the socializing part. And I can't, like, you can't socialize online. You can, but it will never be as fun. Like, it will never be as, like, oh, this was funny in person. It just won't be as nice, because you'll just be sat depressed doing online schooling. Whereas in lessons, you can have some really fun times. So I'm like praying for my social life to kind of stick around, hopefully. I'm not saying focus all your time on studying, but I'm saying if you're going to become a damn doctor, please put some effort in. Don't worry, I'm not becoming a doctor. I'm studying psychology, criminology, and art. So it's fine. The Discord link isn't working. It isn't? Fuck. Shit. Try the link in my about panel. There should be a link in my about panel, and if that one doesn't work, then I can get you a new link and I can update it after the stream. Hello Pyro, welcome on in Pyro, happy Friday. Yeah, try the link in my about panel, and then if that doesn't work, I can get you a new link and I can just paste it into the chat, or someone else can if possible. But yeah, very sorry, that I'm gonna need to write that down, that does not work and I need to fix that. Thank you for letting me know though, I appreciate it. Discord link. It's in the red pen. You got a place on the red pen list, Demon Destroyer. Demon Destroyer, thank you so much for the follow, by the way. I noticed it before I started. You're on the red list. You are on the red list. The important list. If you get your name on that important list, it means I fucked up the stream somehow. How about the movie? The movie? Oh, what? The movie that I'm in, apparently. Pyro, I've never been in a movie. With my knowledge, I've never starred in a movie. If that's what you're talking, I've never starred in a movie. Unless you were watching Driver Dan Story Train, the fucking movie. I've never been in one. I've not been in a movie. I can promise you. Unless my parents signed me up for a movie without my knowledge and I've just blocked it out. I've never been in a movie. You're drawing? Your drawing? Did I miss your drawing? Did I not see a drawing? Your drawing? Did you do a drawing that I've just not taken notice of? When did you do a drawing? Did you do a drawing? When did you do a drawing, Pyro? Am I being stupid? When did you do a drawing? But no, I've never been in a movie. I've been in Driver Dan's Story Train, though. Which doesn't count, because that was a piece of shit. That was a piece of shit. And it was just, like, from a fucking news bulletin. And I thought I was really cool for being in Driver Down the Story Train, but apparently it was literally just everyone. The snowflake? Oh. Pyro. Says the link is invalid or has expired? Oh. Shit. Pyro, are you active on Discord right now? Do you think you could, get, like, a share link and just paste it in the chat if you could? And if not, I can do it. You got in easily? Oh, Demon, it might just be a problem through you, but if not, we can still make a new link and paste it to you so you can get in, don't worry. It's all good. Pyro, are you active on Discord? Could you get a share link and paste it in the chat if you could? I can do it, if not, I'm just saying, thanks Pyro, cheers Pyro. Don't worry Demon, we'll get you your own special personalized link, just for you. And then I'm gonna have to update everything, which is fine. It's all good, it kind of just does turn off sometimes. It just doesn't work for certain people, so we'll get it working. But no, I forget what I was talking about now. Pyro's drawing. I've been meaning to do that drawing for weeks now, and I just haven't done it. I just have not done that drawing. It's because I have the means to, so I will, Pyro, don't worry, I will, eventually, one day I will, don't worry. But no, I've done fucking nothing for the past 2 days, and it's been so, you know what I did want to do? I saw this idea. I really want to go on a walk, but follow a colour. I saw this somewhere, I don't remember where. Basically, you go on a walk, and you, like, get a colour in your mind, And you, like, every time you see that color, you just kind of follow it. So say if you're trying to follow the color purple, and then you see like a purple sign, and then you see someone wearing a purple jumper, and then you see a purple car, you just kind of follow that path. That's what I want to do. But then I realized, I think I know the area I live in too well to do that. I think I know where I live too well to follow a color, because I feel like I know where all the colors are. I know where all the, I feel like I'd just be following nothing and I'd just end up lost, if you know what I mean. I feel like that wouldn't work for where I live, because I've been pretty much everywhere where I live. Pretty much everywhere, apart from the areas where people get like stabbed. I don't really want to go to the areas where people get stabbed. That link should work now, Demon the Story, and if it doesn't, we'll sort it out for next stream. But let's just pray that one works. Thank you, Pyro, by the way. Thank you, I appreciate it. But no, I want to follow a color, and I want to try and do this like tomorrow or something. I just want to put my headphones in and just follow the color purple around and just see where I end up. And if I end up in the middle of the forest, I end up in the middle of the forest, I guess. I guess that's how that works. I don't really know, like, how, when do you end it? When do you end the following color trail? Like, I'm following the color purple and I'm out for 3 hours. When do I stop following the color purple? Do you reckon they'll, like, get to something and it'll be like, oh, man, this is a big purple thing. Time to try and find my way home now. I want to do it. Maybe I'll just track, I'll like vlog it by myself. I've done it before. I went to go sit in a field by myself. I mistakenly, during a heat wave this year, we had a big heat wave for like, I would say like 4 days. It was barely any day, but it got up to like 32 degrees, which in the UK is fucking boiling and like seething hot heat wave levels. So during the heat wave, I hadn't been outside in a while, and I went, I'm gonna go outside. So I walked probably like a half an hour to an hour distance just to go sit for a bit, because I wanted to go and enjoy the sun. It was just the worst idea I think I've ever had in my entire life. Why I thought it was smart for me to go on a walk in the fucking heat wave by myself, I don't know, but it was just the most unpleasant experience ever. Like, why I didn't just do it on a normal day where it wasn't like abnormal temperatures for the UK is beyond me. But I went, I'm gonna go by myself on a walk today, and it was fucking dreadful. I don't understand how people can enjoy sitting in a field by themselves. I don't know if it was just because I'm really warm, but I really don't like going out by myself to do things. I don't like it. I don't find it fun. Unless I've got a destination to go to and something to do there, or like I'm going to like a shop, I won't go out by myself. I won't do it. I will just stay indoors. Because like, what the fuck? I went to this field, I went, oh, I'll just go read a book or something. I sat there for like 10 minutes and went, this is so fucking boring. Like, I've got no one to talk to. I've got nothing to fucking do. It's sweltering hot and the grass is uncomfortable. Why do people enjoy this? Why is this a nice experience to go sit in a field by yourself? It wasn't. It was not. It was frankly quite fucking awful. So I haven't done it since. So I want to try and maybe go when it's not fucking boiling hot outside and just go sit. You're really close to getting a PC. I'm still a while away, but that's good. How would you mean you're close? Are you saving up for shit? I have been talking to my brother a lot about getting a PC, and I've been trying to like get in contact with family members to see if they can help me pay for it, because I'm saving up so that the PC is worth it, because I don't want to buy a PC that just doesn't do what I need it to do, because I need it to be able to stream and run things smoothly, and just like just work. I just need it to work better than the setup that I've got now. I've got the monitor has stayed in my room probably for like a good 5 months now. I've just done nothing. About the movie part, I saw a girl that literally looked like you but very young. What movie was it in? Maybe I was, you never know. What movie was it, Pyro? What was it called? It'd be really funny if I did. I don't remember ever starring in a movie that I know of. This PC I'm gonna get is gonna be good. See, that's what I want. I just want a good PC that leaves me. Show me the monitor. But it's over there. It's over there in a box. Okay, I will. My dad got it for me ages ago, and I've just kind of kept it in my room literally forever. It's just not moved out of my room, because like I've had nowhere to put it. It's in the box. This is the monitor that I've got. Like, it's a good monitor. I've just got nothing to plug it into. Like, it's nice, it's good, and it's a good monitor. I've just got nothing to fucking use it with. So it's just sat in a box in my room for like 5 months, which is fun, but like, it seems like a good monitor. I don't really understand PC shit. I'm literally getting my brother and dad to do it all for me, because my brother and dad understand technology much more than I do. I said to my brother, Silas, if I get a PC and get all the parts for it, you are building it. I'm not building a PC. I will set the house on fire if I try and build a PC. Like, that is your problem. If I have to pay you, I can pay you, but I'm not making a PC. What's your Discord? So you can send a link on there. It is, shit, I don't know. Did the link not work, Demon? Did the link not work? Oh shit, it monitor is not the best. Oh, fuck it. Well, it works. I don't actually know what my Discord is. It's Sugar Daisies and then the numbers are 5911. If you need the numbers, Sugar Daisies and then 5911. And I can send you a link through there if you need it. Now, why is the link not working for you, Demon Destroyer? What's happened? It was working for other people, but no, the monitor is decent and it's fine and it works for now. I don't really give a shit what monitor I have, honestly. I just want it to work. That's all I care about. That is all I care about, is just having a better setup than I've got now, because currently I'm on a fucking Mac that barely runs anything. Like, it just breaks every 2 seconds. This Mac as well, it's not even like a new one. It is probably like 4 or 5 years old. And it is just a fucking mess. I can't update it, so I can't get certain software. I can't play certain games on it. It is fucking broken. Like, this Mac is fucking broken. But it's what I've got for now, and it works if I do just chatting streams. And luckily, I have quite the skill in doing just chatting streams. Luckily, I have the ability to talk to myself for quite a long time, which is good, because otherwise, I would struggle heavily. I would struggle heavily. Macs suck normally. They really do. But it used to be my mum's, and then one day I was like, I want a Twitch stream. So I forced it to fucking work. I forced this to work with like streaming and like OBS and stuff. I had to make it work. I will send you the link now, Demon Destroyer. I'm assuming that's you. I sent you a friend request. I will send you the link now. Hang on, let me add you back, and then fuck. How the fuck? I don't understand. It's fine. I'll figure it out. How do you in? Oh, okay, there we go. I'm really fucking stupid when it comes to shit like this. Okay, I think I did it right. I don't understand Discord, so if I've done this wrong, I'm just gonna apologize. Fuck. Okay, there we go. Okay, it should work. That should work. There you go. I mean, Mac, every Mac, it doesn't matter. Oh yeah, I know, which is why I'm not getting a Mac computer to carry on my streaming, It's why I'm moving to Windows. Mac is a piece of shit with computers. It works for simple things. It works for like school, it works for, literally that's it. School and watching stuff, that's like all it's worked for properly. But playing games is still a really laggy experience. Like trying to download Sims and shit, it's so laggy. So Mac is just bad, honestly. Windows is much better and like Windows computers are much better. So that is my aim, to swap to Windows. It says it might invalid. Oh, I mean, I literally just made it. What the fuck is going on with your thing, Demon Destroyer? I really don't know what's going on with that, Demon Destroyer. Is there, I don't know how to fix that issue, because all the links have been working for other people and I just made that invite link. I don't know how to fix that problem, Demon. I don't know how to fix that problem. I'm really sorry. Pyro, you're a Discord person. You understand Discord. What's going wrong? That's the point of it. Yeah, to do school and watch things. That's literally it. So, I mean, it does its purpose. It's just that's not the purpose that I want it for. It's the purpose that my mum wanted it for, which is fair. She just wanted it for, like, emails and stuff, and then she stopped using it, so she gave it to me. But it's not the purpose that I anywhere close to need it for now. It can barely run, like, 2 applications open at once. If I try and open Safari right now, the stream will just absolutely break. Demon, are you? What? I don't know how to fix this issue with Discord. I mean, someone else just literally got into the server. I don't know what's happening with yours. Is it an issue on your end? Is it like a setting where it like doesn't work? Might be region or anything. I don't know why it does not work. Is it like your? Is it like a setting with your account that like you can't join certain things? Hello, Sally. Welcome on in. Happy Friday, Sally. That's I like the name Sally. Sally with a British accent brings me much joy. Sally. Anyway, happy Friday. Welcome on in. How are you? I live in Europe. Then it should work fine. So do I. I don't see why that wouldn't work. Shit, I don't know why the Discord link's not working then. I really don't know, Demon Destroyer. Is it like a personal setting thing? Have you like got it so you can't join certain things? I'll look. I mean, if not, now that we're friends, we can like try and sort it out after the stream. Sugar, can I tell you something about PCs? Go for it, Pyro. Go for it. But yeah, no. If it doesn't work during the stream, Demon Destroyer, I can try and like talk to you after the stream to see if we can get it working. And then if not, I'm not sure, honestly. But the Discord should be working. It's working for other people. Either way, I'm gonna have to reset the link now. Says your user, this user's banned from? What the fuck is going on with that then? Because that's not true. Huh? What the fuck is going on with that? There's no reason that you should be banned from it. Honestly, Demon Destroyer, I've got no fucking clue. I've got no fucking clue. Nothing like that has happened. Nope. There shouldn't be a reason for that. You know the difference between Intel and Ryzen? No, Pyro, I don't understand PC things. I don't have the brain for PC things. Demon, I don't know what's going on with like your issues right now, but I can see if we can try it after stream. Do you have like your emailed and everything verified? It might be because of some like verification things. I'm pretty sure the verification is quite high on the server right now. Like it needs to be quite verified. Hang on. I don't know if it's just because you need to have quite high verification levels. I don't know if it's because of that. It shouldn't be. I don't know, Demon Destroyer. I'm shit with Discord. I don't understand any of it. So I'm very sorry. But we can sort it out after the stream if it doesn't work during the stream. But no, I don't understand PC things. Yeah, I verified my email. Then I do not know. Then I am very much not sure. Intel can hold only one application. What does that mean? Speak it in simple-minded people terms. Speak it in not technological people terms. Because I don't know what you're talking about there. Oh, fuck my Snapchat, I'm too popular. What can I say? We'll look after the stream, awesome. I'll try and figure that out, and then if not, we'll figure out another day. I'm not sure. What does that mean, Pyro? What does it only hold, Ryzen can hold more applications and do multitasking? Yes. Pyro, I don't understand what that means. Does that just mean that it can do more things? Speak it in simple terms and I'll understand it. I don't understand PC terms. I'm literally just relying on my brother for it all because he got himself a PC recently. And like he built it all and he got all the shit like by himself and he custom built it all, but like I didn't understand any of it and what he was doing. It's like a foreign language to me, PCs. I don't understand any of it, so please elaborate. I've got nothing else to talk about. What do I talk about? What other topics is there for me to talk about today apart from PCs? Because that's just a realm of unknown for me. That is just a realm of the unknown. It's like a fucking magic game. Oh, you know, it is a fun topic. I don't know fully about this, but the developers of Stardew Valley are coming out with a new game. I think it's about like a chocolate factory or something. It looks so cool. It looks so fucking cool. I forget the name of it, which is ironic that me saying it looks fucking sick. I don't remember what it's called. It's like Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, but I think it's, I don't know what it's called. Hang on. Stardew Valley, chocolate game. Okay, hang on. I will find what the fuck it's called. I'm going to find what this is. So I see an Intel can hold one and others lag a bit. It's called the Haunted Chocolatier. It looks so fucking cool. Like, it looks sick. Concerned Ape, they're making a new, like, you have to... Oh, it looks so good. I don't know when it's coming out, but this game, I'm getting it immediately. It's a haunted chocolate shop, and you have to... Oh, it looks so cool. It looks so fucking sick. I want to get that game, because I barely get new games, and that's one that I really want. Hello, Quiet Reach. Welcome on in. Happy Friday. I'm obsessing over the new Stardew Valley developers game, because it looks really fucking cool. It looks really cool, and Stardew Valley as a game is really fun. Rising can do more things without lagging, so I need to get Rising, is what you're saying here, Pyro. In your simple terms, you're saying, don't get Intel Sugar, don't do it. Get Rising. Thank you, Pyro, I appreciate it. I like that you dumbed it down. Damn, you got a flip. Fuck, shut the fuck up, okay? Be quiet. Number one, I've had a flip phone case since September because I broke my phone and then I had to use my like auntie's phone as a replacement and she had a flip phone case. And then I got my stepmom's old phone and this is the case that I've got. It looks so fucking stupid. It looks like I've got a fucking Samsung. It looks like I'm one of those people. It looks dumb. It looks so stupid. Like, I have just gotten so used to, like, flipping my phone open when I need things and having my little card holders in the back. But honestly, I can't even diss the flip phone case. It's not even that bad. Like, it looks like shit. And it looks like I'm a fucking old person with my flip phone case. And when it was bonfire night, I was trying to take pictures of the fireworks. But obviously, because I can't have it like this, because that covers it, I had to hold my phone like this. And I was sat there trying to take pictures of the firework, looking like an auntie on a fucking, like, her daughter's dance recital. Like, you got this, sweetie. You got this. Oh, look at her girl. I'm so proud of her. That's literally what I look like on bonfire night, just because I was trying to take a picture of the sky. It was stupid. It looks like you strapped your belt. It looks fucking dumb, man. Like, I'm fucking 17. I have to rock about with this at college because I cannot be bothered to go get a new case. It's so stupid. But, like, I'm getting a new case. Like, I'm getting a new case soon because I cannot deal with having a fucking flip phone case. But quite good for protection. I won't even diss it. It is quite good for protection because it has that like extra layer between the phone and the ground, and it's got, yeah, yes, what, yeah. You know, my hairdress. Sorry, I don't know where it is. That's not it. I don't think I have it.
Sorry, guys.
Well, I think you've got it. There you go. No worries.
So sorry.
Why are you apologising? It's all good. It's not like I can see you or anything.
Mum reveal. Oh, pong, pong, pong.
Oh, now I've got wires all over my floor. You can maybe use it as a phone stand. Oh my god, it's so... Honestly, I can't even diss the flip phone case. It's, like, genuinely really helpful. You can stand your phone up all good. You can, like, it helps you when you drop it. That's a really bad example. But, like, it's not even terrible. Like, I can't diss the flip phone cases. Like, they're quite sturdy. And honestly, as stupid as the card holder looks, it's quite helpful. Like, it's quite helpful. So, I won't diss the flip phone case, but I'm getting rid of it as soon as I possibly can because it's clunky as shit. This phone is big enough. This phone is fucking huge. I don't like having a big phone. I don't want a big phone. I don't like it. It feels like a fucking half of an iPad. It's huge. It's massive. Look. It's, like, literally almost the size of my face. I don't want it to be this big. And honestly, I quite liked the home button. I quite liked the home button. I wasn't against the home button. I wasn't against the home button. Anyone against the home button here? I mean, swiping, good. It's good. Swiping's good. But clicking a button was much easier. It was much easier. So I'm kind of against it. The home button iPhones were elite. They were, weren't they? I'm against the swiping. I don't like it. It doesn't work sometimes. And it's just inconvenient because you try and swipe and then you like accidentally click on the screen and like fucks everything up. Home button, simple one tap, that was it. The only bad thing about them was that they broke quite often. My flip case protected my phone so many times I dropped. Exactly, it does, doesn't it? It does, it's much better. The PC you should get, Ryzen. But laptop, get Intel. I don't think I'm planning on getting a laptop anytime soon, but thank you for the advice, I appreciate it. If you're streaming, it's better AMD than Intel. Fair enough,
but no.
I can't even complain. Oh, guys, she turned into a 40-year-old auntie because she's using flip covers now. Yeah, I am, you know, and I will happily admit that. I will happily admit that I have to now take pictures like this and hold this fucking thing. Like, when I try and, like, look all cool and in college and I sit and message people, I have to sit and actively open my phone case. That's just wrong. I have to fucking flip... I have to flip open my phone case if I want to message. I'm stupid looking. It's so stupid. It's funny though. Home button is the best. I like the delay though. It's the best. I like the home button. I really liked it. The home button was great. I don't like the flippy screens. I can't breathe. I get that it like takes up less space, but I wasn't that pressed. I wasn't that pressed about the space. I would take the home button back. You need to go out and take photos with an iPad or a huge tablet. You got this, sweetie. You got this. Oh, I'm so proud of her. I'm so proud. You got this, sweetie. Like, it's so unironic. Now I'm actually like a middle-aged auntie. I actually am. I put my glasses on, put my reading glasses on, and then I've become fully, I'm now like a 6-year-old. You got this, sweetie. I'm proud of you. Just like really zoomed in as well. Just really shit. Just look like that. Oh, doesn't she look so nice? I've become an auntie, everybody. I'm directly post all the camera roll into Facebook. This is, okay, no, you can't even have it. This isn't a flip case. This has got the keyboard on it so I can do my schoolwork. See? Ta-da! And all the Twitch notifications that I missed. Whenever I have, like, all my Discord and Twitch linked onto both my phone and my iPad, so I just constantly get double notifications all the time. It's so fucking loud. If I ever get a Discord notification, I'll get, like, fucking 3 of them if I have it open on my computer as well. It just never ends. It never ends. But no, I've become a middle-aged dad. I'm aging very fast. I'm 40 now. I'm 40 and I'm going to my son's football game and my daughter's dance recital tomorrow. How's everyone else doing? How's everybody else doing today on the stream? How's everybody else doing? I love Facebook and Farmville and Candy Crush. I love Candy Crush. It's great. I'm on level 487 and I'm only going up from there. I'm gonna neglect my kids so I can play Candy Crush. I'm going to ignore my 4 children so I can play Candy Crush and Farmville. How's everybody else's day doing? But no. What's mum's obsession with Candy Crush? I would have thought that that's like a game that like old people wouldn't get addicted to. What's Candy Crush? Like, what's the massive appeal? You know, I feel like someone should do a video essay on what the appeal of Candy Crush is to old people. Because I thought that it wouldn't have been like, oh, I was a bit distracted, I need a cup of tea, I'll be back for more madness and active, that's all good, I'll see you in a bit. Sound like my mum. I'm going to neglect my kids and play Candy Crush. Hello, Fire Turtle, welcome on in, happy Friday. But no, someone needs to do a video essay on the connection between Candy Crush and being like over the age of 40. What's so addictive to, like, why is it so addictive to old people? Why? I've never seen anyone my age really actively enjoy the game Candy Crush, ever. I've never seen anyone actively enjoy the game Candy Crush. So what appeal does it have to people over the age of 40? Why does swiping the candies together make so much serotonin in old people's game? Candy Crush is easy and rewarding for them, I guess. But, like, why? Why? I mean, like, fair enough, but like, my mum got stuck on a level once and she got really mad at it. Like, why have they just got the full brain capacity to fucking bish bash bosh slam out like 8,000 Candy Crush levels in a fucking week? Like, where does that ability come from when you're 40? Because I'm shit at Candy Crush and I'll admit it. I've always been quite bad and I'm too impatient for it. But like, I feel like when I'm 40, I'm going to be ready to bish, bash, bosh Candy Crush levels out of the bag. You know what I mean? Right now, I'm bad. Like, what's the connection? Why is it so good to their brains but bad to mine? I don't get it. I don't understand it. So I want someone to do a video essay on it. I want someone to look into the psychology of it. If I ever get tasked with my own psychology thing in my A level, that's what I'm going to look into. If I ever make a video essay, expect that. I guess we don't have the attention span to grind up levels on Candy Crush. I guess so, but 40-year-old aunts do enough to neglect their kids and like have to email the developers saying that they need more levels of it. There's so many different ones as well. I don't understand the appeal. I don't think I've ever downloaded Candy Crush in my life. I think I can happily say I don't think I've ever had Candy Crush downloaded onto my phone. I've definitely had like versions of it downloaded onto my phone. Never Candy Crush. Just never had Candy Crush. Quite proud of that, honestly. I've fallen to app like game ads quite a lot. I'm quite a victim to game ads. I'm quite bad with it because I'll be like, oh, this game looks fun, and it's just a fucking load of lies. I hate when adverts do that. How do they get away with it? How do like games like Homescapes get away with just absolutely lying on adverts? That's got to be against some kind of law. That has got to be against some kind of law to go, hey, you fix a kitchen in this game, and then it's literally just Candy Crush 0.2, but with, like, homes. How, like, that has got to be against some sort of, like, advertisement law. Because that's just not true. None of it's true. Like, I understand if you kind of put the game concept in and then change it a little bit, some had, like, some weird side plotline to it. But if you've just advertised a whole different game, that has to be against some kind of rule. Because that's just going, hey, this is what you're getting, and then it's not what you get. Or is that just me, like, making up a lore about game ads? All game ads are lies? They are. They'll do some weird-ass fucking plotline, and then you'll get a game, and it'll literally just be Candy Crush, but with different textures. Like, how are they allowed to do that? I don't get it. And I'm quite a victim to it. I'll go, this game looks fun, and it's just not real. If the actual games were the games that they showed in ads, I can guarantee you they would get so many more plays and so much more money. So what's the point in lying? What's the point in lying? Just make that fucking game. If you make an advert for it, make the fucking game and I'll go play it. I'm not playing Candy Crush again, but with fucking dogs this time. Like, it doesn't have the same appeal if you lie to me. But I'm very easily tricked by them all. I don't like game ads, I'm against them. That's why I really like Danny Gonzalez's Bad Ads series on his channel. I find it very entertaining, because some of them just don't make any fucking sense. If you're a victim to it and you end up installing it and try and play it, then the ads work. But it's a piss take. It bothers me every time. I've not been a victim to it many times, and all those ones I have been a victim to are usually quite accurate. You can tell when the game's not real. You can actively tell. Like, if it has one of those weird-ass convoluted plot lines, like, my grandma just killed my mum. Oh, man, now I have this old house. I'm gonna go fix up this old house. Oh, but the house burnt down. I think you can tell that that's not real, but some of them are like, this looks like a real game, but it just looks like a really shit, like, sandbox game that looks entertaining for 5 minutes, and I've been tricked by them, because I find them games really fun. I find really mundane games quite entertaining. I really like mundane tasks in games. Like, that is my favorite thing to do in games. My favorite thing to do in Minecraft is fish, and it always has been. Fishing in Minecraft used to be my least favorite thing when the mechanics were quite bad. The old fishing mechanics in Minecraft, they were like a fucking crime. They were like a crime. The old fishing mechanics in Minecraft are the equivalent to Stardew Valley mechanics. Dreadful. Dreadful. Oh my god. It just used a bob and then it just a boom down and you miss the fish. Now you get the little water stream and it's nice and you can see when the fish are there. I much prefer fishing in Minecraft now. I love fishing in Minecraft because it's an easy task and it's good rewards. Fishing in Minecraft, best. They don't care about installs, they don't care if players keep playing those type of games. Fair enough. Then play RuneScape. I've had that suggested to me multiple times and I've just never looked into it. I just really like mundane things. I like just like strip mining and getting more cobblestone in Minecraft, or like fucking just grinding the trees in Stardew Valley. And I mean, that's literally the only two games that I play, but that's not the point. I just like mundane tasks. I used to always look up cleaning games. You know the website Girls Go Games? Yeah, elite fucking website. It was so good. I loved Girls Go Games. It was the best. Cool Mask Games? Yeah, it was alright. But was it advertised towards girls. Was it all pink? No, no, no. Could you play a game that was like Elsa gives birth, then dress her up in the hospital? No. Cool Maths games didn't have any of that shit, but Girls Go games did. I loved Girls Go games, and I used to always look up cleaning games because I really liked cleaning games as a kid. Found it really satisfying to clean everything. Found it really happy. I liked just seeing it all get all cleaned. I'd never clean in real life. Fuck that. Who do you think I am? I'm not cleaning in real life. But cleaning in a game, oh, it's just the best task. I play RuneScape a lot. I don't really care that much for it. I just haven't really looked into it. I think I just don't play games enough to buy new ones. I bought a load of new games for stream like a while back, but it's all been too laggy, and then I'm saving Undertale for like a longer stream. I really like cleaning looks of the mess behind her. Hey, that's not even that messy. It's when you get over to this side of my room that it becomes a fucking shambles, okay? This behind me, that's the neatest part of my room. That is the fake reality that I am living in this stream. This is the cleanest part of my room because it's my bed, and I keep my bed like religiously clean. Over there is the corner of denial. It's the corner of denial. We don't talk about that corner. And we don't talk about this corner either. You'll never see this corner because this is a corner of shame. This is a corner of fucking shame where I've just got boxes. Do you want to see my boxes? Do you want to do a box tour? We can do a box tour if you want. I've just got many boxes that I just filled with things that I just pretend like these don't exist. These boxes, they're not real in my mind. I have a chair of denial. I used to have that, but I sit in my chair too much for it to be real. Look at my box of denial. Look at the shit I've got in my box in denial. It's just colouring books. It's just colouring books and shit like that that I just don't ever touch. This was my pencil case from year 7. Do I need it? Fuck no, I don't. Fuck no, I do not need this. But it's in the box of denial, okay? You know what it says on the back? Stay away from me. I was such a cool, edgy year 7. Look, more things in the box of denial. Another colouring book that I haven't touched. More things in the box of denial. Just shitloads of random paper. But it has cactuses. That's my reasoning. I am going to throw it away though eventually. Look, just a box. Unopened. Not used. It is just a box. And it stays in the box of denial. It's like a fucking loophole now. It's like a loophole. Look at this. Oh, I can actually utilize this. Box of denial is helpful. I can use this to wrap my mum's Christmas present. I am keeping that. See? This is why the box of denial exists, everybody. So it can help me. Look at this. Look at this shit. Fuck even is this? What the fuck is this? What's this meant to be? I know what it is. It is a drawing from my year 4 class of a boy in a cage. Not in a cage. A boy in a cave surrounded by bats. That's what that is. Moving swiftly along. This shit. I don't need this anymore. And it's in a plastic wallet. Who the fuck? Why do I don't need this. It's not got any memorabilia behind it. This hasn't got some reasoning. This wasn't like drawn by my ex-best friend. This is just here because it is. It's fucking, look at it. It's dreadful. Look, it's fucking dreadful. Batman origin story. Yeah, boy in a cave surrounded by bats. There he is. And it's got my name on the bottom. Look how scared he looks. He looks fucking shivery. He's shivering in his boots there. He's quaking. He's absolutely terrified. Look what other things I've got. Did you draw the brutal murder of his parents too? Mm-hmm. I've got a photo album, which I hope doesn't dox me. Here I am. Look, there's me at a wedding. Just ignore that. To be honest, if I show my brother, will that dox him that much? Do you reckon I can show my brother as a kid? Do you reckon that's like a no thing that I shouldn't do? Does showing my brother as a kid dox him? Or do you reckon that's fine? Because he's 20 now, and he was probably like 7 in this picture. Were you blonde? You did see that. Yes. Very. This was my natural haircut. Why do I look so fucking sunburned? Why does it look like I've got tan lines? Yeah, very. I was. You have to get his written permission. Fuck it. I don't think it doxes him that much. It's too late now anyway. There's me and my brother. as kids. It's fine. He's the older brother. It's not like I'm doxing my younger brothers. He's old. He can deal with it. There's me and my older brother. That's me. That's him. We were both very blonde and now we both look the exact same. Just absolutely just the darkest hair possible. There's another picture of me looking absolutely fucking terrified in here. Terrifying, I should say. Let me put this down here so I don't accidentally dox my entire family. That's not doxing family on stream. That would be a bad idea. Where is it? There's a picture where I look fucking awful. I've got like a monster in my hand and I look fucking dreadful. Hang on, let me look at it. Let me look through and see if I can find it. Apparently I hid at this wedding. I hid from all the pictures because I didn't want to be part of it. There's me again holding a piece of confetti. That dress is fucking ugly as shit. Imagine having that as your colour scheme for a wedding. But there I am holding a piece of confetti with my bleach blonde hair. Luckily no one's face is in that picture. There you go, that's my photo album that could have really heavily doxed me. Then we got a bunch of random books, just a load of random books. And then this is my favorite thing, personal favorite thing in the will this dox me? No. Personal favorite thing in the box of denial is my book. This is my not book, this is not a book. My plastic wallet of memories. Now this plastic wallet is full of memories. The title is quite simple. You probably didn't have your current fashion sense at 3. Or what, really good? Really good. Imagine going to weddings. Could never be me, I've been to 2. That's my brother, that's not even me. Look, here's the Batman origin story. There he is! Growing up to be a boy. Growing up to be a boy with bleach blonde hair. I think that's my brother. That or I'm just doxing some random child. It's a card. Yeah, it is that. Wait, what? Why is this addressed to me? Why is this card addressed to me? This card is addressed to me, but it's got a picture of my brother on it. What does that mean? Why is it addressed to me, but it's got... I'm gonna put that card down. I'm gonna put that card down. Box of mysteries, random child photo. That's pictures of my little brother. I can't show that. That's pictures of my little brother. I can't show that. It's just pictures of my little brother. This is a picture of me and my old dog. I used to live in the top of a studio when I lived in Norwich. Obviously, my dad's a drum and bass artist, and we used to live over the top of, like, a music studio, I believe, or it was, like, a shop. We used to live over the top of either a studio or a shop. This is me there in my really appropriate clothing, and my old dog Randall, he was a bulldog. There I am with my bleach blonde fucking bald ass head. There I am. There's just loads of pictures of me, really. I'm just a really self-centered person, so I've just kept them all. That's a picture of my little brother. I don't know what any of this shit is. What's this? Oh, this is my book review of Dan and Phil's book. Because in year 6, I didn't read books and I never have read books, but the only books that I owned were Dan and Phil's books, who were YouTubers from like 2016. They're still around, but like they were really popular in 2016. And it's just like the characters consist of Dan and Phil and lots more. I did like the characters as they are famous YouTubers. They made me feel happy and excited, as I love the book. This book doesn't have a plot because it's all about their lives. It's very fun too, as it is not at all writing. But most of it is, and then you get to learn more about them. I really like the book, but personally, I didn't have a favourite part because I enjoy all of the book. So I just fucking waffled during my, like, book exam thing. I made it up. Here's me in, I believe, year 5? Shit, this could have been year 6. This might have been year 6. I think this was year 6. I think this was year 6. Open box of denial, create content for viewers. Shut up, singing voice, we're trying to hear W all the way. Yeah, this was me in year 6, I believe. I had a massive headband phase. I'm not bald, I have hair. I just had a massive phase of wearing headbands to the point where it looked like I was a bald middle-aged man. I don't think I've changed that much personally. Like, look at this, look at me now and look at this. I honestly don't think I've changed. I don't think I've changed too much. I think if I went like that, I'd look basically the exact same. So you're still a bold middle-aged man? Yeah, my hair's just a bit darker. I didn't even change my hair color. Like, I've never dyed my hair once in my life. Here's me in, I believe, year four. So this was a 2-year difference. I couldn't smile. I didn't have the ability to smile as a young child. I didn't know how to smile. So that's how I smiled. That's how I smiled in year three. I did it bad. Your nose remained the same. Is it gonna change that much? I'm gonna put on different music while I talk quite a lot and go through my books. We'll put on wordless music. This is what I look like. Yeah, so I had a really weird side part in. I rocked the side part in. And I just, it looks like I've straightened half of my hair. If I had a side part in, that would be an exact resemblance. So I didn't know how to smile. Had the inability to smile. The chin and the nose, they've stepped the same. Stepped the same, kept the same. This is my graffiti of my name. It's really fucking good. Look at that. Look at the graffiti. Oh, that's so cool. That is so cool. You look like the emo version of that little girl. I actually do, don't I? Oh, why did you bring that to light? I fully do. I fully look like I've gone emo. This was a picture and I ripped it up by accident. Now, onto my favorite thing in this entire thing. If this doesn't bring some sort of like awful reaction to you immediately, you're a really fucking lucky person. Okay. Now, you know how I was talking about how I really liked Dan and Phil as a kid? We went to a pottery painting party. That's a really fun alliteration. A pottery painting party, okay? And everyone else painted normal things. They painted like flowers and they painted like the ocean and shit. And I went, I'm going to paint my favorite childhood YouTubers. So this plate becomes absolutely unusable in any sense. It says, the cat whiskers come from oven, which is just a heavy Dan and Phil reference. And this plate makes me want to cry. Looking at this plate makes me want to fucking have a breakdown. So that plate is just awful. And then, I don't know if this will dox me. It won't. This was me in year five. You can see the headband phase is going fucking strong. Look at that fucking picture. Fucking look. Why do I look different in every single picture that's ever been taken of me? Ever. This was a year apart. What happened? Why do I look different in every single picture taken of me? I've not stayed the same at any point throughout my life. These were a year apart. Probably not even that, okay? What the fuck? Who's this? Who is this? Whereas the person that does the fake news stories, these photos will be useful. What, Ben? Don't bring Ben into the chat while these are popping up. Oh, I fucking get abused. So yeah, that was me in year six and year five and year three. And then, does this say my last name? This doesn't say my last name. This was my music stars developing bright future certificate, which I got during my music lesson at school. And it says, Sugar was full of ideas today when it came to making actions for the firework sounds we were copying with our voices. Her fantastic listening helped her to learn and remember the sounds quickly. Well done. I was a star from the young age. What can I say? I'm just actually an elite individual. But no, there's not only one of these. There is in fact two. I got two awards. The second one was from actual PE, that says my last name, was from an actual PE lesson. Yeah, I did sports, where it says, Sugar was excellent in PE today. She worked really hard all lesson, showing good floor work and never giving up. So well done. I'm just actually elite. Imagine if that was a photo of some other random girl and it had me by mistake. It wouldn't shock me, honestly, if I've just got another random picture of some random kid. The next one is my best girl dancer award. We had when we did discos, in the discos, one boy and one girl would win an award for the best dancing. Now, during my years from reception to year six, I won two of these awards. My crystal just dropped out my necklace. I won two of these awards. Kids Zone is what they decided to call it, though. Kids Zone. I can't put this anywhere near anything. I can't have an award that says Kids Zone at the top of it. And it says Best Girl Dancer. And it has a really shit looking trophy on it. So that was one plastic wallet. I'm pretty sure without doxing myself. Is it bad to show pictures of my entire primary school class? No. There's me being a narrator. There's me there. Just ignore everyone else. In the bright pink cardigan. That's me. I was a narrator in my year two play. That's me right there. How interesting and fun. And then here's my picture book. I used to draw a lot as a kid because I was awesome. This is my picture book. Does it say my name on it? No. No, it's fine. These first pictures, they're all of Moshi Monsters. Why was I crying? I wasn't crying. I was just looking down. We were getting off the stage. Narrator, that makes perfect sense. Shut the fuck up, okay? I didn't even want to be a narrator. I was like the only person in my class who could sing, and I got the one non-singing role. Because no other girl would be a narrator, and they didn't want to look sexist. So I had to be it. They fucking hated me. So these are my drawings of the Moshi Monsters. This is my drawing of Kermit the Frog and Miss Piggy, an animal, and like the Meep Meep guy, I forget his name. These are my SpongeBob people, as it says in the title. These are my SpongeBob people. That's Patrick, that's SpongeBob. As you can clearly see when their hands are like that, just like in the cartoon. And that's the only drawings that I did in this book. I obviously didn't care that much about this book, but that was that book. I don't think there's anything more in this which I can show without doxing myself. Oh no, that's not of mine. So yeah, I believe this is maybe me. It could be my brother. We looked the exact same as a kid, so either way. But no, I had to be a narrator so my year six teacher didn't look sexist. So basically they just singled me out as like the only girl that wouldn't put up a fight because I was really quiet. Every other girl wanted to be a dog or an angel, and I had to sit there narrating. I fucking hated it. I had about like two lines probably. My lines was like, then Mary dropped Jesus off at the fucking barn or whatever the fuck they dropped Jesus off in. But yeah, that's my first plastic wallet full of memories. But we're not done yet, my friends. There is a second plastic wallet full of memories. It doesn't end there. No, no, no. You think I hoard small? No, I hoard everything I physically own, okay? Any little thing that has had an impact in my life is in this box somewhere, okay? I think I was a wise man or something. I hated that shit. I wanted to be the dog. I was really quiet. Damn, what the hell happened? Did you fall into radiation? No, I was just a ball of nerves as a kid, and I hated like getting told off in school, so I was fucking dead silent. This is me with a piano, having my music career from a young age, as you can very clearly see. I look like a boy in all of my pictures, but there you go. This is just another proof of me not looking... To be honest, I think I look more like myself in that than I did in any of like the recent pictures. I think this looks more like me. This looks exactly like my little brother. Then we've got... I don't know what this is. Oh, my favorite memory of school. When Joe was an egg in one of the plays and he fell off the thing and Miss Wilson thought he was really injured. I remember when I had to take a selfie with Mr. Marriott. We were terrified. I remember when we were with Miss Edwards and she went into the class and everyone went, attention. When I grow up, I wanted to be a photographer, a YouTuber, or start my own career. Look what I've done, everybody. I wrote this in year six. I have had the aspiration to be a content creator since fucking year six. What is wrong with me, man? Like, what happened to me in year six that made me want to be a fucking YouTuber? Jesus Christ. This is a picture of my old dog. There you go. I think Elton John still uses a similar one, but you're halfway there. See? I'm moving up in the world. This is a bunch of random cats. I don't even know what half this shit is. I'll be honest with you. This is me and my two childhood friends. at a zoo, I believe. There I am. You can spot me out quite clearly with my bleach blonde fucking hair. What other shit do I have in here? No, that's of my little brother. Here's a WoW card from my old... Basically, whenever you did a good thing in secondary schools, I literally have to cover half of this, otherwise it would dox me. You got a thing called a WoW card. It's basically just a card. This teacher was basically like a fucking pedophile, and he gave me one. It said, superb input and application this time. He was literally a pedophile. I shouldn't have kept that. I should have put it in as evidence to the fucking police. Honestly, like, what the fuck? He was a freak. But yeah, no, my keyboard was before my time. Here's me with my dog. There I am. My fucking terrifying elephant in the background. That dog, best dog I've ever had, really. There I am. Literally look the exact same. I don't think I've changed that much apart from the fact that I've got eyeliner on, honestly. What else have I got? That's quite boring. That kind of just nothing. Here's the story of the rainbow. If you guys don't know the plot line to the rainbow, I'll show you it now. One summer day, there was a cloud, a rainbow, and a sun, and they were having a wagwan for the fucking what? Hello, hi, welcome on and happy Friday. I'm reading the story of the rainbow. Wait, what the fuck? Where did I go from? They were all having an argument. Do you know why? I know why. Do you know why? I do know why. Well, where was I? Oh yes, one day it rained while the sun was shining and it made a rainbow. And then they had an argument again. There's just two full pages of the word again. I'm gonna skip you the fucking pain of that. But just then, everyone noticed that they need all of them to make a rainbow. But Rainbow said, no, no, no. You two are the best. I'm the most fluffiest, said the cloud. I'm the most hottest, said the sun. I'm my cloud and sun and knowed what it was. Then the most colourful and... Yeah, I forget other sugar, age six by sugar, Illister sugar. The end. I don't know what I just said in that. I'm not sure what I just said. Nice story, now shut. No. What the fuck? Fucking hell, man. Jesus Christ. I'm just trying to read my fucking story about rainbows, and you're over here. What the fuck, man? Stop interrupting my story of fucking rainbows and suck your mum, man. Jesus Christ. I was just trying to read my fucking story. Oh, piss off. I'm not in the fucking mood today. I am not in the mood. No. I'm reading my story. I'm not getting interrupted. No, man. She underage. So long. Bye-bye. Painting. Sugar streams are the longest monologues on Twitch. Yeah, hey, red and yellow and pink. Look with your ears. Listen with your eyes. Listen with your ears. Thank you so much, DN Destroyer 2004. I appreciate it. So that was the story of the rainbow, everybody. You just got back. Welcome back. Happy Friday. So that was the story of the rainbow. My favorite part was the bit where the narrator got really sidetracked. I don't know why the narrator broke the fourth wall so much in this fucking story, but had an argument. Do you know why? I do know my why. Well, where was I? Oh, yes. Why did I sidetrack from the story? Why did I sidetrack? And then, what the fuck is that? I didn't realize this was a fucking page in the story. Who the fuck are these people? I didn't know this was part of the story. I don't remember this part of the rainbow. We'll just move along from them pages. Also, at the end of the story, I'm pretty sure I just didn't finish it. Am I cloud? And then the sun. What is it? Then the most colourful. Oh yeah, I forget. Other. Sugar, age six. By sugar. I spelt my name wrong. I spelt my own name wrong in my own story. I spelt it with two G's. How the fuck do I spell my own name wrong and then spell it right two more times? So that was the rainbow story, everybody. sorry we got interrupted during that. That was fucking weird as shit. What other stuff is there? There's a picture of Taylor Swift. I was a big Taylor Swift fan as a kid, so there's that picture of Taylor Swift. That's the same picture as me and my dog. Christopher Nolan sidetracks into alternate realities and considered a good storyteller. Yeah, but mine made no sense though. Aw, this is how to take care of my dog. I wrote like a guide on how to take care of my dog as a kid. How to look after Randall. 1. Give him a comfortable bed. 2. Feed in the morning. 3. Give him a nice bowl of water. 4. Let him out 3 times a day. That seems wrong. 5. Love and cuddle him. 6. Walk him. And that was apparently Randall's tree. That's quite a big tree. Randall hates fruit, is what it says. I feel like letting my dog out 3 times a day was animal abuse. I feel like you should let them out whenever they need to. I don't know why it was specifically 3 times a day. Why weren't you a fan of the Rainbow Story? I already liked the Rainbow Story. I thought it was quite good. I thought it really showed a new perspective to the rainbow. I think it was quite good. What is this? Oh, that just straight up says my last name on it. Literally half of this shit doxes me. It's really funny. These were my really edgy drawings of Harry Potter characters in year 6. This was my only style of drawing in year 6, drawing people with square ass fucking heads. I've never seen Harry Potter before in my life. Never ever seen Harry Potter before. There's some random vampire woman there. I think that's meant to be Harry Potter. That's meant to be the owl. That's some like deranged like pigeon or something. And that's a sheep. And that's a flying pea. From what I remember, that's the plot of Harry Potter, or like 7 of the fucking movies. And they're all zombies. I got a great effort stamp for it though, so my teacher obviously really liked my Harry Potter drawings. Why they didn't send me into like to get help? Never seen it, so just guess. Yeah. If you live in your apartment, it's better to schedule your dog's bathroom breaks. No, I lived in a house. I don't know why I was scheduling when my dog could go outside. This is a picture of me looking at rabbits. That place got like harassed by teenagers later on in life. This was my golden award for prop making in year 6, apparently. Oh my god, rabbits. Yeah, that place got broken into by teenagers and they smashed all the pens up. What a fun backstory, sugar. How much did I lighten the mood there, guys? Then I've got some random CD. There's a picture of me watering stones. I was very invested in watering the stones. And here's a random CD with my name on it. There we go, I'm watering stones. Pivotal part of my career, that honestly. I was a stone waterer. I was a stone waterer. I was very important. Did they go into the rock? Maybe they did. Maybe I was the rock origin story. Me. All me. That straight up says my last name. I've got to be really careful with this shit. What's this? That is just my school report. I should be much more careful with this. Because like this is the most doxing information I've ever brought out on stream ever. This is just straight up got information about everything I've ever done in my life. I feel like I should be much more careful right now. This is a card that someone drew for me of my dog, apparently. Didn't really work that well. But there it is. You're not going to read us your school report. No, it's just numbers. It's literally just numbers. My cousin had a rabbit, had red eyes, fucking scared the shit out of me. It's just numbers. Like my attitude to learning was excellent in English. Good in maths, good in art, good in science, excellent in drama, satisfactory. That meant bad. That meant bad, guys. That meant bad. Satisfactory was bad. That was them saying you need to pay more attention, but in like a nicer way. That doxes me. That doxes me. That doxes me. That doxes me. What is this? That also doxes me. So there you go. There are my 2 poly pockets of memories. Do you want to look in the other box of denial? It's not even done yet. There's still another box. Like, I have many boxes of this shit. Like, unless you don't want to, I'm completely up to look through the other box of denial because it doesn't end. Oh, here's a picture of me in nursery. That's in nursery. That's before nursery. That was like a before nursery thing that I went to. And I was a right charmer. Look at me. I was a fucking, I didn't get told to do this pose. I did it by myself. Hey, nursery staff. I was a charmer. Jesus. I'm pulling from a young age. Look at me. Fucking hell. Why is all this stuff just sitting here? Not even shoved in. I mean, it's in a box in the bottom of like a plastic wallet. This was my dog book. It's got pictures of dogs in it. I fucking love this book. Of all the dogs. This is how I look when I get back to them. No. I was posing. Now I've got to try and put it all away and not dox myself. This is the hardest part. But yeah, I've got a full another box of all this shit. I literally just keep stuff. I just keep things. We don't have a loft or... And the bottom of my wardrobe wouldn't fit it. So it literally just stays in the bottom of these plastic boxes that I just kind of keep in the corner of my room. Constantly, forever. Because, like, I've got no place to put any of this shit. And I, like, look through it. I think the last time I looked through this was on stream. Okay. What? You guys didn't see that message, but I did. I'm just gonna ignore that. But yeah, no. I just keep it all. I don't know why. I just have a really bad thing with keeping literally everything I own. This is the story of me, the Wiggles character Dorothy, and my dog. I'll read it to you. One day, Sugar and Randall. I didn't do this one. My mum did. So you're not allowed to diss it. Went out to look at the roses. I doxed myself, probably. Sugar don't even know. She told us her full name and where she lives. Oh yeah, I 100% did. I probably have, but you know, it's too late. They saw a hat and a funny sound. Hee hee, it said. Why have I found Michael Jackson? Why have I found Michael Jackson in the story? They saw a hat and heard a funny sound. Hee hee. It's, why is Michael Jackson in the why is Michael Jackson in the bush? What's Michael Jackson doing in the bush? Mike. Oh, it wasn't Mike. It was Dorothy. On crack cocaine, apparently. Why does she look like that? Let's have some rosy tea. How lovely, they all said. Bye, Dorothy. We love you. And that was the story of Dorothy and Randall. Is that green beanbag with a tank on top? No. It was Dorothy the dinosaur. How could you not know? Maybe he was looking for cocaine. What, Michael Jackson sitting in the bushes looking for cocaine and children? Anyway, moving swiftly along. So that was one box of denial. This just literally stays in my room. And it will forever. It won't ever leave. I can guarantee you this. None of this will ever leave until I cleanse my entire room one day. So you learned fun stuff? What fun stuff did you learn today? I probably did dox myself though, because that's literally just all like my family personal information in there and shit. So let's just pretend like that never happened and we'll move swiftly along from it. Yeah, let's just like all of you guys live in denial as much as I am about these boxes, about what I just said and showed to you all. On to the next box. Isn't this fun? This gives me something to do. This was my journal where I tried to do bullet journaling things in it. I take it back. Apparently, it's the story of the rock. So here we go. A story of the rock. You know how I was watering the rocks? Apparently, now I've got the story of the rock. I'm not sure. I'll read it to you. I like how you all looks like the side of a cow. Thank you, I appreciate it. I painted it last year when I was having a breakdown. So here we go, the story of a rock. It's not that exciting. The rock is capitalized as well. Capital T, the, capital R, rock. Dwayne the Rock Johnson, your wrestling fandom face. I don't think it's got anything to do with that. I think it's just like, I was trying to write my own story. It all started out when the group was strolling down the road on a nice sunny day when Ellie found a rock. She looked around. Did anyone else see it? I guess not. So she put it in her pocket. Shh. Hey, Ellie, Sugar yelled. Come here. Come her. Okay. Come her. Okay, coming, Ellie said. And that's the end of that story. So I'm not really sure why I wrote the story of the rock. I'm not really sure where that. I don't really know where that came from. And then I've got all my spelling things because I had to make spelling lessons for my brother in lockdown. How did the story end? It doesn't matter. I don't fucking know, do I? And then this is the side where I tried to be all Pinterest and bullet journal-y. Not with the origin story of The Rock, apparently. So that's just one. The story birthed the wrestling and act of the superstar The Rock. Yeah, it did. That was me. It was all me, guys. This is just a load of paper. I think I literally just shoved all this shit in here when I was cleaning my room because I needed a place for it to go. This is a daily planner that I've never opened in my life. But to be honest, I actually could use that. I'm going to keep that out. That's going with the wrapping paper. This was my drawing of bees. Eventually winning the sexiest man alive due to... Yeah, yeah, that's exactly where that story led to. This was another planner that I never touched in my life. It's empty apart from the first page, which has a load of colourful lines on it. And other than that, it's completely fucking empty. There's quite... You'll notice a theme here. You will notice a theme. Here's another 2019 planner that I never fucking touch. There's not a single word in this book. Oh, no, there is. There is. Things that currently make you happy. Family, friends, YouTube journalizing. It's just like a load of fucking lies, really. And just me being really insecure. Daily Planet is my Superman with bees for background, please. Bees. There's the bees. Good the bees. I like a de bee. There you go. Bees. I can't see. Whoa. I had a real big phase of drawing bees because they were really easy to draw. So that's my 2019 planner, which I never touched. Now, here's the opposite of what I'm talking about. Here is a planner that I was about to say that I touched a lot, but I feel like that sounds bad. I use this planner, I use this notebook religiously, I think from year 7 to year 8. You really want to be a YouTuber? Yes. Now, I know there is a page solely dedicated to Dan and Phil somewhere in here. This is the first page. I think you can see where I'm going with this. This is the first page. Look at it. Look at her fucking legs. Look at her legs. What the fuck has happened to her legs? Why is she so disproportionate? Where's her arm? What's her arm doing? What? She doesn't have a shoulder either. Leg. Look at her fucking legs. Feet cut off. No, they are the feet. And it says on the side, it says, love is a part of life. I was so edgy. So that's the first one. Apparently not an art YouTube page. No, the second page. This is the second page. Do I need to explain why this is just awful as a page? I had a thing where I couldn't draw on hands, so I just make them look like their hands are behind their body. I thought this was probably like the shit when I was a kid. I thought this was so good. The next page, this is the Dan and Phil page. This page honestly isn't too awful, apart from the fact that it's all Dan and Phil related, which makes it awful. You see the whiskers have made a comeback. It says, Jesus on a boat. Hey, guys. I promise I'll buy you an alpaca. Step aside, peasants. Oh, bother. No, not the whisk. You're better than toast. This is a sexy elevator. Existential crisis. Oh, existential crisis. So I think this just shows how much of a piss take I was. Then there's this. I don't even know what the fuck this is meant to be. I know it's meant to be an eye, but holy shit, is this just awful. Look, it's like my eye, but I'm not crying. I'm gonna move straight past that fucking page. Then there is this. I don't really know what this is. I think I was trying to draw a comic. It says, what did you expect? I'm not a doctor. Wait, I am a doctor. So I'm not really sure what that means, like at all. And it's upside down as well, so it's a fucking dumbass page. And then this is my drawing of Totoro. It's fucking shit, it's shite. How fucking awful that is. And I dropped my book in food. And then there's another one of them, you'll notice a theme in my drawings. Everyone was square and this. And then that was also upside down. Then there was this. I really couldn't draw. You feel like you're spinning? Are you okay? Are you doing okay? Are you alright? And then, yeah, then there was this. Look at the fucking legs. I could not draw legs to save my life. Then there was the phase where I sat and drew mandalas for ages. And honestly, I can't even fault myself. These are quite good. Like, I was quite good at drawing these. Like, from a distance, they don't even look that bad. I had a massive phase of just drawing these fucking everywhere. So, I like these pages. These pages aren't awful. Spin. It did a spin. So, those pages aren't awful. I was quite proud of those pages. Whoa, it's the universe. Yeah. And then... and then it goes downhill again. With this. That start of a drawing, and whatever the fuck she is. Fucking awful. I don't know if my uncle put vodka in this drink, maybe gave me the wrong- Are you doing okay? This says, I've been staring at the edge of the water, it's a Moana lyric. This is my patterns page, I believe. It's just a load of shit. I think this was me trying to draw Moana. I don't even fucking know, honestly. This is the start of my drawing of Jake from Adventure Time. Thank you so much! What the fuck? Thank you so much for the raid, Eloise. I really hope I'm pronouncing that right. Thank you so much for the raid. I appreciate it. I hope you're okay. Happy Friday. Welcome on in. Welcome on in, everybody. How are we all? How are we all? Thank you so much. I appreciate it, though. We had a lovely stream. We're going through my box of denial currently. In my room, there are two boxes of denial. Which I pretend like they don't exist. But thank you so much for the raid. I really appreciate it. I hope you have a lovely stream. What are you guys up to? Welcome on in, everybody, though. We're going through my really shit old notebook from when I was in year 7. How's it going? It's going absolutely grand. It's going grand. How is everybody else? Yeah, we're going through my really shit old notebook from year 7. You all joined. You didn't join on that. You had a great stream. How am I? I'm doing absolutely... You've joined at an excellent moment, let me tell you. You have joined at the prime of this fucking notebook. This was my attempt of drawing Moana in year 7. I had a massive Moana phase. When you cover the light in the camera, it looks like you're in a Rolls Royce. Oh, I can look rich. Oh my God, I'm so rich. You got to go. Okay, bye-bye, Quiet Ridge. I hope you have a lovely rest of the night. Everyone has those boxes? Yeah. That box, I just pretend like they don't exist, really. I just pretend like they're not real. So this is my drawing of Moana. It's fucking dreadful. Look at that. I couldn't, and this was my attempt of the drawing of, like, I don't remember what it is, but the fire person from Moana. Then, it just goes even more downhill. This is the only notebook I, like, actively used as a kid. This is my drawing of Groot, apparently. Look at the fucking shading on the pot. I could get an award for that shading. It makes so much sense. And then this. Then I began my Pinterest phase of drawing in my notebook. Then I began the phase where I wanted to draw like the Pinterest people. I think this is only bearable because number one, I didn't give it legs. And number two, I didn't have to draw a face. Is that a hand? Is it a hand? It's more of like a... It doesn't really look like a hand. And then I gave up again and just wrote hello. I did that quite a lot on the DS. And then I wrote intertwined because it was a Dodie song and I was obviously feeling quite edgy that day. I didn't even want to show you this one. I don't want to show you this one. This one's... This is the next page. Where do we even begin? I'm going to begin with the words. It says, ABC is easy. Why have I got, isn't that a Jackson 5 song? ABC is easy, it's like counting 1, 2, 3, say it's simple, Mandy. What, how is that, how relevant to what's going on in this picture. How is that any... Why was I putting on a fucking, like, Jackson 5? Fuck it. What? What? And I wrote it all edgy as well, with fucking dot, dot, dot at the end. A, B, C, Z, Z. And then, sage your hair, I'm going to read. A monk's want to ask the sage, how does enlightened one return to the... Oh, fucking hell, I can't read that. To the ordinary world, the sage replied, a broken mirror never reflects again. Fallen flowers never go back to the old branches. The heavens never accepts the fallen of Lord of the Stars. For I am sage. Welcome on in, sage. Happy Friday. Thank you so much, Soul Reaper. I appreciate the follow. I appreciate it. I found out that once my dad got drunk on a mad Friday, dressed up as a princess, hugged a policeman, and then the policeman started to cry. Oh, I see. Huh. What a fun time. Let's carry on with this drawing. Let's carry on analysing whatever the fuck is going on here. What are these meant to be? I think these are meant to be tents. Why is that relevant to what's going on in this picture? Nothing has any cohesion in this picture. Not a single thing has cohesion in this picture. Why is she holding a balloon? Why does it say Jackson 5 lyrics in calligraphy? Why is there fairy lights everywhere? And why is there a bunch of tents? She's at a really shit version of Glastonbury here. Well, obviously Jackson 5 are headlining, and that's the only way I can... Then, this is the new evolution of this book. I got massively into the game. I don't know if any of you know the game, but Doki Doki Literature Club. I got into Doki Doki Literature Club heavy. It's a game, and I got into it massively as a kid. And I went through a phase of just copying fan art from people. So every single one of these next pages are only kind of bearable, kind of being the important word, because they are just real. Okay, no, they're shit. No, they're actually really shit. No, they're really shit, aren't they? Okay, I take that all back. It's true art. Thank you so much, energy. Thank you. She's bringing a balloon to a fairy village while singing Jackson 5. That's the only thing that makes sense, isn't it? A, B, C is easy. Let's go over to the tents. So even though I copied these fucking line for line, they still look like shit. I used to draw these everywhere as well. I used to draw these three pictures everywhere. Why do they still look so fucking awful? Okay, and then borderline improvement. Not much. Not a lot. But slight. Slight improvement. Just a tiny bit, okay? Just a little bit of improvement. Like, it's still shit. It's still really awful. You can see it's awful. But considering where we begun in this sketchbook, it's not too bad. And then it went back to that, so that was fucking useless. And then I gave up. Aww. And then I didn't ever finish the sketchbook. But from where we begun and where we ended, we went on a journey. It began with Dan and Phil and it ended with Jackson 5, apparently. To be honest, we didn't fucking get anywhere. Look at the first page. All we did was add a load of tents and Jackson 5 lyrics. I did not evolve at all within the 2 years I had this sketchbook. I made no sort of improvement. I went from drawing this to drawing a Jackson 5 concert. Same position, same balloon. There's just no random fairies. It's just snowing or raining, and love is a part of life is there instead of Jackson 5 lyrics. So I made absolutely no improvement. So that's the only sketchbook I've ever tried to keep, and then the rest of them in this box are literally empty. I think that's a poem. Oh, this was my version of Postman Pat song, but if Postman Pat just did crack cocaine. I've got no reason for this being in this box. I've got no fucking reason for this being in this box. I don't know when this was made, because It was in secondary school at some time where I rewrote the Postman Pat theme tune to just him being a crack cocaine addict. And I'll sing it for you now. And I will sing it for you now. It says, I'll read it, I won't sing. It goes, Postman crack, Postman crack, Postman crack, and his black and white stack. Which number one doesn't make sense, because I don't think there's black crack cocaine, but we'll go. Late in the evening. Oh, thank you so much, Bunsy the Lord, for the follow, I appreciate it. Late in the evening, when everyone is sleeping, he buys his crack and stocks it in his van. Carrying on. I don't know why I own this. I'm gonna carry on. Okay. Postman crack, postman crack, postman crack, and his broken down shack. His whole body is stinging, and his ears are ringing. Pat feels he's a really normal man. Everybody hides when he's around. All people will run as he comes to get you. Definitely, he can always be sure there'll be knock, ring, policeman at his door. So that was that. We're gonna move swiftly along from whatever the fuck that is. I don't know why that I have that. Oh, here's another edgy notebook of mine. So that was Postman Crack, copyrighted by me. The fairy village was burned by the snow. Sad story. Oh, it's so emotional. These are Dodie lyrics. Dodie the singer. There's a funny one, Barbara, actually, have you any rock? Oh god, claps rock poetry, thank you. Thank you very much, thank you very much. I know, it was so original. Dodie, the singer, these are just lyrics and I thought I was really cool because I added like fancy words to them. I added like letters. It's literally all just Dodie lyrics. I was going through a really edgy phase in my life. Oh, Attention by Charlie Puth. It, you just want attention, you don't want my heart. You know the one? Yep, that's there. Waving for a Window from Dear Evan Hansen. And Mama Who Bore Me. It's just a load of fucking waffle, basically. I'll have a drink. My water's almost gone. That's upsetting. Chin chin. So that was that edgy booklet that I, like, made 2 pages in. And then the only other thing I have is another poem I tried to write. But this is just absolutely dog shit. Like, this was the shittest I don't even know how to explain this. But at the time, I thought I was fucking Shakespeare 2.0. I don't know how old I was when I wrote this. I'm gonna assume probably around year 5. And if it was any older, then this deserves to be burnt. Because this is a piece of shit. Like, my inspiration for this poem, I remember my exact inspiration for this poem, was onomatopoeias. I remember Googling onomatopoeias for about an hour to write this poem. And you know what? I'll read it to you. As much as I don't want to, I feel like I can't explain it and give it justice without reading it to you. So the plot point is that it's a doctor's appointment and there are 2 characters, one of which can only speak in onomatopoeias and the other one being the doctor. I think it's also in alphabetical order, but I don't know where that's relevant at all. And I think I tried to make it rhyme, so it makes no fucking sense. I'll begin. A chew, a hem. What's wrong, ma'am? Already a red flag. It doesn't rhyme. Thank you so much. I don't know how to pronounce that. Captain. 51584_5. Thank you so much for the follow. I appreciate it. So, a chew, a hem. What's wrong, ma'am? Bad start. Doesn't rhyme. Bam, bam, bash, and boom. Please excuse. Already another red flag because it just doesn't rhyme. I don't know if I was trying to make it rhyme, but I think I was. Carrying on. Beep, bong. Beep, bong, boom. I reused boom. And then it says, it's meant to say just, but it's fine. Then it says, no, room. Hello, Ace of Spades. Welcome on in. Happy holidays. Happy Friday. I'm reading, happy holidays. I'm going Australian. Happy Friday. I'm reading my poetry. I'll continue later. Cheep, chirp, chatter. What's the matter? See, that rhyme, quite proud. D- ding dong drip. Something happened at the tip. See, this is where I was trying to make it rhyme, so it just became absolutely illegible. Fizz, flip, flop. Can you just stop? Underline twice in capitals. Gurgle, giggle, gurgle, groan? I don't think this line's appropriate to read. I don't think this line is appropriate to read, everybody. I don't think this line is appropriate. I think this line, out of context, sounds really bad. Hey, it's Slippy in here, can I stop? No. It's a bad line to read after that fucking message. Okay. I don't think I want to read this anymore, but I will. But for the sake of the content, I will. Giggle, gurgle, groan. Do you want me to moan? Moving swiftly along. How hiccup hiss? Please, miss. Jink, fucking hell, I can't carry on from that. How am I gonna recover from that fucking line? And once underline. Jingle, jangle, jump. Did you have a bump? Kaplunk, ka-ching, knock. That was a bit of a cop-out, wasn't it? Stuck in a sheep flock? Meow, munch, mutter. I'm in a flutter. Oink, ouch, ooze. What did you lose? Spelt with a Z. Ping, poof, pow. Rammed by a cow? I think that says quack. Quack, ribbit, rote? Rote. Roke? I don't know what that says. Slam by a door? A roar! It says roar. Sploosh, splash, statter? Again, what's the matter? Thud, tweet, trickle. I'm in a pickle. Whip, whoosh, whoop. Tied in a loop. Zip, zang, zoop. My brain is poop. What was I saying? Onomatopoeias. Oh, that's my disease. So it's the end. Pop. Oh, here we go again. I thought I was fucking Shakespeare when I wrote that. I thought I was being innovative when I wrote that poem, with one of the lines being, do you want me to moan? I was reversing any sort of movement we made in English. I was reversing any kind of movement we made in the English language by shut the fuck up, Matt, okay? But they're trying to brainwash us. I think I brainwashed myself. I don't even know what to say on it. Honestly, there's very little times I'm speechless on a stream. This fucking poem has made me speechless. But the fact that I've kept it, it's golden. I can't throw it away now. I can't throw it away. The next thing that comes out of this box is a drawing of Kermit. If he fucking got burnt or something, I don't really know. This was like a big thing on like 2019 TikTok. They're you so fucking precious when you smile. I spent so long on this. I spent a ridiculous amount of time on this. I made all the fucking emojis accurate and all. Like, I spent so fucking long on this just for the Kermit to look like a piece of shit. So that's the next thing that comes out of the denial box. Speaking of rivers, here's my picture of a waterfall that I never finished. And speaking of waterfalls, here's my picture of a fish that I never finished. Next thing is a big notebook. We're just gonna move swiftly along from that fucking poem because I don't even want to think about the poem anymore. Welcome to Sugar's second sketchbook of the stream. It says Sugar's notebook on the front, and then that's a load of me trying to figure out a signature. That's not my signature. Let's begin. Strong start, honestly. Strong start. It's a picture, I believe, I was trying to copy the, like, unicorn cat thing from the Lego movie. So it's a... But, like, on a tree, I don't really know where this part's relevant or where the rest of the page is relevant. But we're just going to move swiftly along from that page. That's where it began. So it was a strong start. The rest of the page is... I don't know what the fuck this is. Oh, no, it's happening again. What the fuck is this? Who's this? It's a mushroom. bathroom man. See, I can't explain this. I have no explanation for why that's there. Super Mario trying to eat a mushroom. What's this then? Who's that? Why have I given it a penis? Okay, we're gonna move swiftly along from that. That says, loves it with a cactus. I don't really fucking know. This is my Spanish revisions, and it says, got in shower sugar by hand from mushroom. I don't know what it is. This was my really edgy thing that I made that says sugar D, which stands for sugar daisies, if you ever wanted clarification. I thought that looked quite cool, and it actually does. That's like the best thing that's in this notebook. This is a load of Pokemon eyes. I remember actively sitting and drawing them. This page just says no, that page says ho ho ho. This page, I remember. Some of you won't know. Basically, as a kid, I had a bubblegum scented pen that was like crack cocaine for me. I drew this with said bubblegum scented pen. It is a picture of the sun saying, I'm gonna burn you. And then it burns the people. And there's two happy faces at the bottom. And I drew that with my bubblegum scented pen, which I think proves how fucking high it made me feel. This is another really good drawing of mine. Really showing my artistic abilities. And then this is loads more Pokemon eyes. To be honest, they're not fucking dreadful, but it's because I copied them all. Oh god, I've just seen two pages along. It just only goes down here from here. This is my drawing of someone in a dress. I don't even understand the anatomy. I don't know where to begin with the anatomy of this. I honestly, what the fuck has happened to her arms? I don't even want to try and even begin to explain that, so I'm choosing not to. Is then it says a load of British YouTubers. It's just nothing. This was my YouTube subscriber list in probably like 2016. We got David Dobrik. You're gonna show you. This will just exactly show my taste of YouTubers. Liza Koshy, The Gabby Show, LD Shadow Lady, Game Theory, Daz, Daniel Harrell, Smosh, Markiplier, Rosanna Pansino, PewDiePie, Zoella, Superwoman. It's very 2016 YouTube, but it was great. I had a lovely time. I don't fucking know what that is. This was me trying to solve the Einstein puzzle. Fucking hell, what the fuck is this? This is fucking horrifying. What the fuck is that? Who the fuck is this? It says monster. He is the cutest little monster in town. Is he now? Because that's fucking traumatizing. What the fuck is that? That's awful. That's fucking awful. We're gonna move swiftly along from whatever the fuck that is. I think these fucking books could like check me into a hospital of some sort. They're dreadful. They're absolutely. Welcome to my really edgy quote. This was my really edgy quote. It says, life doesn't revolve around you. It also doesn't revolve around me. It revolves around the sun, you dweeb. Nah, JK, it revolves around my freaking dog. If you needed a clearer look into what I was like in year six, that is exactly what. I think the sentence, nah, JK, it revolves around my freaking dog, shows a lot about what I was like in year six and how just unlikable of a person I was in year six. So there you go. That's... This was me testing my pens. Do you want to know how much unlikable I was? It says, hello, yas, lit, and raw. I was just the most unlikable person you could ever meet. I honestly, there's no fucking surprise I didn't have friends. No fucking surprise. I was just awful. Why did I write raw? You know, I've got a backstory behind this next picture. This picture, I was obviously really upset on the day, and it says, "Wow, thanks guys." And it's a person of picture crying, someone crying. I think I had a falling out with my friend group on that day, and I came home, and a really healthy coping mechanism, I drew a picture of a girl crying. What the fuck was wrong with me? Like, what was actually wrong with me? This was all my stickers. I fucking loved these stickers, and I didn't stick them for ages until I stuck them on this book. I actually like that page. What the fuck is this? That's just that. Fuck, that page couldn't fucking die. That page was all my music taste. This page, I've never been more proud of something in my life. I drew this all with Sharpies, and I remember posting it on my Instagram page when I was a kid. But it is just straight up copy of something off the internet. Like, it's just a bootleg. I copied it, like, pixel for pixel. But I remember being insanely proud of that. What other things is there in the book? There's me playing squares quite a lot and me not being able to do maths. I don't know what this page is meant to be, but like, it's not awful, and then this page is fucking dreadful. We don't need to bring that page up. It just slowly goes more and more downhill, honestly. Like, I can't describe half of these pages, but like, it was literally just when I picked things up. I just picked up the book and I just used to just write shit in it, and it makes no sense. But you know, here we are. It's like my streams. I go live and I just say shit and it makes no sense. Where are there active volcanoes in Hawaii? Ring of Fire. Is that what that page says? There's a packing list for when I went out to go camping, because I couldn't take a breath in my life. This is fucking dreadful. This. I have no words for this page. If you couldn't tell, it's a girl in a dress with what I'm pretty sure, if you look closely, are scars on her wrist. I was in year six when I drew this. Year six. I was 10. What the fuck was going through my head when I was 10 to draw this? Or just some bracelet? No, because look on her neck. It's meant to be scars. I'm going to move swiftly along from that fucking page and go to the next page, because I don't want to know what was going through my page, what was going through my head. I don't want to know. I will stay in denial about fucking that page forever. This is why it stays in the box. This is why it stays away in the box forever. And it will never see the light of day now ever again. So that was that booklet. I terrify myself. I'm a terrifying person. I'm terrifying. I'm awful. I'm actually just dreadful. This is my Dan and Phil phone case that broke my phone and we couldn't get it off. This is a bunch of stickers. This is a board game. This is actually just shit that I've hoarded that I don't need. These next three boxes is literally just shit that I've kept and not looked through, and I just can't be bothered. It's got like pens, scissors, just like rubbers and shit. Like, it's just a load of fucking like Velcro. These boxes are just shit that I don't need. It's got an old toothbrush in here. It's got notepads. This is I used to make stickers for Will and Eve when I was a kid. Well, when I was in like year 7 or 8, I believe it was, I made stickers for Will and Eve and I put them around the school. I don't know why, don't ask, honestly. I put them around the toilets and stuff. You should pay me for that. It was literally free promotion. Like, I don't know what to tell you. I used to like free, I used to give Will and Eve free promotion around my school. I used to stick them literally everywhere. So, you know, I think I should get paid for that. I would have been good at marketing. So there you go. They were my two boxes of denial. You're welcome, everybody. That was a good insight into what I was like as a kid. Fucking insane, apparently. Especially with the line, something happened at the tip or whatever the fuck it was. I was insane is basically what we've concluded from this little exploration into Sugar's child brain. You're welcome? You're welcome? I don't know if that's a thing you should be grateful to have seen. That's why it stays in the corner. That's why it's going back to the corner and I'm not looking at it ever again. Anyway, I love that segment of the stream. What about you guys? What about you guys? It was an experience. It surely was. It really was. And honestly, I don't want to be that person. But I think it's a good time to end, because I don't know how I can elaborate from whatever the fuck just happened there. I don't think I can elaborate any further. Oh, I missed this. This was my drawing of paint. There you go. You're welcome. I don't think I can elaborate any further on what just happened. I think that's it. I think that's me done. What else am I meant to say? Hey guys, I'm Sugar Daisies. How are you all? Like, I don't think I can improve off of that. So I think I'm going to end. I think this is gonna be it for the stream because I think that's a fun, nice closure place. Also, because my stream has just been fucking lagging for like the past hour. Bees for background on Twitch. What, you want the bees? Why do you want bees? Do you want the bees? Why, Matt, what do you want? Bees? Why? What do you mean, bees? What do you want me to do? What are you asking for me? What are you asking from me? Bees? Bees. You wanted to change your daisies? No, I'm keeping it daisies. It sticks with the title. I'm just drawing snowflakes instead. But that was a good idea. That was a good idea. Anyway, I'm going to end up my first ever, not ever, my first in a while, 4-day in the week stream. I won't be back until next week Monday now, so you're all gonna have to miss me for 2 whole days. You're all gonna have to sit there and go, ah, 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 I'm so sad I can't hear any of Sugar's childhood poems anymore. I think I might cry. But don't worry. Don't worry. I'll be back on Monday. It's okay. You don't have to. I'm not going for too long. You wanted to change. Yeah, I've read that message twice, which is why I think I'm gonna go to bed. Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. I'll be back before then. Fucking hell, I won't be gone for that long, Matt. Jesus, I'll be back next Monday. I'm not disappearing until next year. I'll literally be back on Monday. You don't only have to miss me for 2 days, not like 2 whole weeks, just in case. Shut the fuck up, okay? Well, that's fair, but no, I'll be back on Monday because I don't have to go to college anymore until next year. So I've got nothing better to do, so why not? Anyway, I'm gonna end up now. I might sit in the music VC on Discord. I might not. I don't know, because I need to get some artwork done, or I might literally just go to sleep. But either way, I'll be back on Monday. I've appreciated you all for being here. I've appreciated the raid and all the followers that we've had this stream as well. It's been really nice of everybody. I will see you all on Monday, 7 p.m. GMT. I will be back, probably doing a very similar thing to what I did today because my Wi-Fi is just too awful for anything else. I hope you all have had a happy Friday and or Saturday, everybody. I hope you continue to have a lovely week and have a lovely, happy Saturday and Sunday as well. I will be back Monday. Eat, sleep, and drink well. Have a lovely afternoon, morning, dusk, dawn, night, other times of days. Other times of days. And I will see you all on Monday, everybody. I appreciate you for being here. TikTok and Discord links are in the bio. Not the bio, the about panels. And I will see you all on Monday. Don't miss me too much, everybody. Bye-bye.